That you are pretty easygoing. You're actually probably more easygoing than I am.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Well, there's no, you're not easygoing at all.
Hey!
On 100.5 ESPN, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Jen Latta, and yet right now I'm so mad at Jen Latta. I'll explain. Edition. The someone I can never be mad at, even though he takes a lot of credit for being ahead of the curve on Jordan Love and all his brilliant Badgers knowledge, the Badgers outsider, scheduled to appear in his farewell appearance for the year. Edition.
I thought you guys had him as a farewell last when I was gone.
No.
Am I crazy?
No, you're crazy. Edition. Of Wilde and Tausch. Also, where's Wilde and Feel Good Friday and all that other good stuff?
We didn't want him without you, buddy.
Buddy. On 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee, 100.5 ESPN Madison, 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
Longest farewell I've ever seen. That's a long farewell.
Especially for a guy who'll be back next year, I would presume.
He hasn't been on since they lost to James Madison.
It's fair. He was beside himself. ESPNWisconsin.com, the ESPN app, your Alexa smart speaker, streaming live video, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and of course everything you need on WisconsinOnDemand.com and the Wisconsin On Demand app. I'm Jason Wilde in Green Bay. Jesse Nelson is in the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios. And from his bellissimo undisclosed location, he is the Packers Hall of Famer. He's Mark Tauscher. Tausch, good morning. How are you?
I'm doing all right. What bothered you this morning? What did Jen say to you
If you missed yesterday's show, Jesse, with a brilliant tease, that paid off huge. But if you didn't stick around till 11:15, you had errands to run, you had a meeting to go to, you didn't get to hear it. We had Mel Kiper on a few weeks ago. He joins us once a year. I was trying to twist Tausch's arm to get him back on right before the draft, and he said no, he wouldn't do that to his friend.
No, I said you could. No, I told you you could call him.
Okay, good. Then I will. I will. And so Tausch had besmirched his reputation, allegedly.
According to Mel.
Allegedly.
Yeah, according to Mel.
By saying that in the 2000 Mel Kiper Jr. draft guide, no Mark Gerald Tauscher appeared. And then, after Tausch departed on his vacation to Italy, we got a voicemail. And it wasn't just any old voicemail. It wasn't from Chef Ed, who we love. It wasn't from Jim on the South Side or whoever it might be. It was from someone of great renown. And Jesse played it yesterday, and he's going to play it again right now.
Yeah, this is for Mark Tausch, or Tausch, as they say, who has been talking about Mel Kiper, never had me in the book, he forgot about me, didn't know who I was, didn't give me anything, gave me no love. Mark, I wrote you up, I scouted you, I gave you a sixth-round grade. Now you're destroying my credibility with all these negative comments and make people think I had no clue who you were, that you even played college football, that I was completely out to lunch. This negativity's got to stop. I gave you a write-up. You were ranked. You were rated as a sixth-round pick. Last time I checked, you went in the seventh round, so I kind of overrated you with the sixth-round grade, but I did write you up in the book in 2000. So stop, please, with the negativity. You are trying to destroy my career of 46 years, and I don't have 6 years. Appreciate it.
That's fun.
Trying to destroy my career of 46 years. So.
And he doesn't appreciate it.
I don't blame him. Besmirched. He was besmirched.
Yeah.
And so I say, all right, I'm pretty adept at internet usage and online shopping. Big thrift store guy. Love my trips to Goodwill. I'm going to find the 2000 Mel Kiper draft guide. I find one as a pack of six. I mentioned this on the show yesterday, that on eBay, there was a set of six Mel Kiper draft guides. One of them was 2000. They were asking $103.95. I believe I even asked to borrow $103 from you. Because, yeah. Contrary to reports about a luxurious pool in our backyard and our stately manor that we live in.
Leave. 2.5 quarters. Yeah,
which I didn't pay for because there's someone else's.
It's all the safety features.
Paula and I are not wealthy. For those that are friends with me on Facebook who saw that I was selling hangers, you probably are already aware of that. So I send a message to this eBay seller. Hi, you're not going to believe this story, but I do a radio show here in Wisconsin with a former NFL player who's actually supposedly in this book. I'm wondering, would you be nice enough to sell me just the 2000 guide, and then you can sell the other ones in a bunch? I get a note back a few hours later. Hi, thanks.
Nerd.
Hi. No. 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 Cheap.
Yeah,
cheapskate. The person writes back, hi, I would have been happy to do that for you. That's a really cool story. But someone just bought the entire set, so I can't do it for you.
Good for them.
And I'm sitting there going, who the hell is buying old 20-year-old Mel Kiper draft guides on the day that I want to buy the 2001 to affirm? Or, and I have not ruled out this possibility that Tausch is right and Mel is wrong. I think it's highly unlikely. I think he's got a copy of his own book, and he probably checked it before he left the voicemail. I'm not ruling it out.
As someone pointed out on the text line, Tausch still wanted to fight it. Mel wrote the book. It's like telling the author of any story, no, it should have ended this way.
Yes. I'll have to admit, I'm pissed. I'm like, what are the chances that someone of all days would buy this? Who wants Mel Kiper's old draft guides? So this morning, I appear on Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. And amid the nonsense of Chewy going to a pierogi restaurant, which I didn't know what that was. I thought that was the type of sandwich that you get in Pittsburgh. Apparently that's not the case. At the end,
like potatoes. There's something with potatoes in it.
Yes, that's
pretty good.
I learned that. Kind of like a dumpling, I'm told. At the end of the appearance, Chen unveils, I've got something for you. I'm really excited. Yesterday, for $103.95, I bought the 2000 Mel Kiper draft guide. So, Jen.
The ESPN national money. Jen's just throwing that cash around.
Wealthy.
All right.
So yeah. And it was $11.95 for shipping on top of that. I'm sorry.
Wow.
I wasn't willing to do that. And she bought the whole set. She's the buyer. So now she will be in possession of said book. She is going to appear on our show. She is not going to open the book. When it arrives, she's going to keep it closed. And then she is going to reveal, along with all of us, all at the same time, she will learn the fate of Tausch's draft analysis, if it exists in the book,
so
with all of us.
Was Chewy one of the other draft grades? Because then it actually makes a ton of sense for Jen to buy that.
So Chewy was...
Was it like 93? When did Chewy get drafted?
92. He was drafted in 92. So I'll double check my messages in my eBay account to see what other guides are in there.
You know what? And I know this is a fun little deal, and we love Mel. It's fun. I always have thought, my older brother always thought, you know what would be a really cool deal is if you did a redraft every year after the first season, and you could get that look. And I also think it would be fun to go back and look at the evals. And I know Mark Murphy did this with Goody before you hired him, went back and looked at the evaluations of some of the players the Green Bay Packers had on their team to see how accurate it was.
Sure.
We all get so caught up and excited about this pre-draft chop and old Newton down in Illinois and everything
else. Good old
Newton. And then you draft, and it's like, oh, A-plus on the draft, and then you just move on. And then 2 years later, you say, well, half these guys aren't even on the team. What a crap draft. Or like last year, what a great draft. You got all these. I think that's one of the big holes in media coverage is the actual delving into what happened 2 to 3 years later when you can actually make a decent examination of what Goody or any of the other general managers did.
So the draft guides that Jen will be receiving, 1996, 2000, 01, 02, 03, and 04. So in case you're wondering, unless you, if you really want to do a deep dive now that she's got all the books, the 96 draft was the John Michaels draft when Ron Wolf thought he was getting Ray Lewis. And the Ravens took him on the pick before, and as Ron has admitted, he figuratively got caught with his pants down and took John Michaels, who was not very good. The 2000 draft, how do you think your 2000 draft was good?
Yes.
Bubba Franks, Chad Clifton, Diggsy, Stevie Warren, Niall Diggs,
Baja Biamila,
Kabir, and then you were one of four, five seventh-round picks.
Jason,
that year.
And Brady if you look at it, you could have had
Brady.
Tom Brady, and Favre wouldn't have the all-time interception record if that was the case. Although Brady never plays. Favre didn't get Bledsoed.
Right.
So Brady never plays. Right. Brady's probably selling insurance,
right,
and nobody knows about him if the Green Bay Packers draft him at 224.
Right, passed on.
Or when they grab Big
passed
Juicy.
Passed on Matt Bowen, too.
Matt Bowen. So I think if you're looking at a draft, you can either get one stud a la Jordan Love, because can you look back at the 2020 draft? The rest of that draft wasn't very good, right?
You still got A.J. Dillon on the team. Still got A.J.
Okay. You're looking at that 2020 class for as many guys that didn't pan out. Anybody going to sit here and tell if Jordan Love is the guy we all think he's going to be? Anybody going to say that wasn't a good draft? Now?
So,
no.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
So that the one pick is all it takes? Or is that a Goody stand talking?
One franchise quarterback is all it takes, yes.
Because that, and I know I have the reputation of being too critical of him. But you've got A.J. Dillon.
I feel spited. You feel like you were spited.
No. A.J. Dillon. A.J. Dillon is still on the team. A.J. Dillon is still on the team. He was sitting courtside at the Bucks game too, across the floor.
I saw him. I was sitting two rows behind him.
But everyone else from the 2020 draft is gone. Josiah DeGuara. John Runyon was a good player, so I think he deserves credit for that, even though they didn't bring him back. Mm-hmm. But that draft is gone. And frankly, 2021.
Not great.
Eric Stokes, Josh Myers, Amari Rodgers, Royce Newman, T.J. Slayton, Shamar John Charles, Cole Van Landen, Isaiah McDuffie, Kylin Hill. So,
Jason,
the 2021 draft,
what you just said from 2020, we disagreed. We both thought the timing of that draft pick, even though Jordan Love now 4 years later, I'm not revisionist history. What grade are you given if Jordan Love signs a new deal and is the franchise quarterback for the Packers for the next decade?
And
you're
good.
Telling me you don't give that draft class an A?
I give that pick an A. I give it an A+.
No.
Even though
it
I didn't think
all
should,
comes back.
No,
you have to.
I don't
look
think
at
you
big
do
picks.
That. Do you think that? All right. So do you think Goody grades drafts based on if I got one good pick right, then I had a great draft? I would hope he doesn't feel
that
way.
No, but I think when you get a franchise quarterback pick right, that is a multiplier of 5x. And you put John Runyon in there as a starter for 3 or 4 years for you, and he's going to get you a comp pick coming back. The other guys gave you a year or two. You're hoping normal draft you get 6 or 7 picks. That's a normal draft.
Mm.
Maybe 8 or 9 now with all the comp picks. But
11.
Let's just call it 7.
Yeah.
Let's just say there's 7 picks that you're going to get. If you get a franchise quarterback and a starting guard for 4 years. And everybody else is kind of whatever, I still look at that as a very high grade because you have a franchise quarterback. Now, if you get if you don't have Jordan Love and you just get Runyon, that's a D. But the franchise quarterback will elevate it up to an A.
Yeah, I understand it turns out to be a fantastic pick if he's as good as we think he's going to be.
And totally you have A.J. Dillon in there who's had some moments for you.
Again, I like A.J. Dillon. As a fifth-round pick, if he has those moments, you think, God, what a great pick. As a second-round pick, it's the same as the A.J. Hawk versus Blake Martinez. Two guys that wore number 50 and got a crap load of tackles for the Packers. No one thinks A.J. Hawk was a great pick, even though he was a very productive player for a decade. Right? No one
Laura Hawk thinks he's a good pick. I think he was a really good pick.
Because he's one of your good friends.
Was he Ray Lewis? No, he wasn't Ray Lewis. Jason, he's the all-time leading tackler in the history of this franchise.
I understand, but when you pick fit, you're telling me. Take the fact that we both like AJ and he's a friend of our show and he's a good human out of the mix. You're telling
me. He's a really good NFL football player.
As the fifth overall pick, your expectation for the fifth overall pick isn't higher than A.J. Hawk being the all-time leading tackler.
A.J. Hawk was a captain on a Super Bowl team. He didn't miss games, and he was the all-time leading tackler. Would we all have loved to see him make more impact plays? Sure. A.J. Hawk was everything you want in a linebacker.
And a teammate. I get it. I'm not. A.J. Hawk finished his 9 years in Green Bay with 9 career interceptions, 19 career sacks, and a ridiculous 922 tackles, according to Pro Football
And you're saying
reference.
That's incredibly disappointing?
No, I'm saying that when you – wait a minute. You're doing to me what you always hate being done, and that is – it's always based on people's draft pick and where they're selected, and that goes into the expectation
game.
But
you act like he was a bust. There's a difference between being a really good player and a bust.
All right. He's not a bust. But when he's the fifth overall pick, getting a guy that accumulates tackles and has 9 interceptions, he forced 4 fumbles in 9 years. And again, this is not a knock on him. He was a very good NFL player, but if you pick him, do you think teams that are picking fifth this year would be happy if that's what they got at number 5?
If you gave a team that needed an inside linebacker A.J. Hawk's career for 9 years, I don't think people are that bummed out about it. You want to have.
Are you sure you're not allowing your friendship to factor in?
Everybody wants Lawrence Taylor and Ray Lewis. Hey, there's also a lot of other players that can't play a lick. So, yes, of course, you want a top 10 pick to completely transform your franchise. A.J. Hawk did not transform your franchise, but you know what else he did do? He won a world championship and had a big old C on his chest when he did it.
I think my issue is not with the player he was. I am talking about the expectation game. Are you a better draft pick than A.J. Hawk?
Well, from a value standpoint, yes.
That's all I'm saying. You were both fantastic NFL players. But if I get A.J. Hawk in the 3rd or 4th round, I'm not saying any of the stuff that I'm saying now. Just like Blake Martinez was fine.
In the grand scheme of things, it doesn't really matter.
Well, no, you don't do that. That's not fit. You are the king of the expectation gang. That's what you always talk about.
I don't think AJ fell as flat on the expectations as you guys do. You and Homer both are acting like he was like some middling player. He wasn't.
He was never.
You can't play 9 years in the league, Jason, and be a starter and a captain. And be an all-time leading tackler for a historic franchise and be some middling, like, disappointing.
He went to one Pro Bowl. He went to one Pro Bowl in 2010. Yeah. For the fifth overall pick? And again, I don't want to be painted as now I'm trashing A.J. Hawk. That's not what I'm doing. I'm talking about as the fifth overall pick. take away his draft status completely, and I say all the things you did. Captain on a Super Bowl team, reliable tackler, great guy in the locker room, great teammate, leader, all those things. Those things don't disappear. But when you talk about expectations, which you do all the time, we talk about how first-round picks have to prove they don't belong in the league, while seventh-round picks constantly have to prove that they do. A.J. Hawk, as the fifth overall pick, is not a impact player that you expect with one Pro Bowl from the... Now, you're also right. You go through the fifth overall picks, there's a bunch of them that didn't do jack that they missed completely on. He's definitely better than them. But Miami took Tua at
I'm
fifth
not
overall.
Saying, Jason, I'm not saying for a fifth overall pick that he lived up to the fifth
That's
overall
all
pick.
That's all I'm asking. Then
but
why are we
all
arguing?
All I'm telling you is he had a really good career.
And I agree
think if
with you.
So I don't even know what we're arguing then.
That's what. Well, I think you just. No offense, but I think the light bulb just went on above you because you said, "I'm not saying for the fifth overall pick." That's the whole point. That's the only point here.
But there's so many.
Our assessment
but Jason,
of him
there's
is the
so
same.
Many fifth. There's so many other first round picks that can't hold a jock to AJ Hawk's career. So there's a give and a take on this, and yes, everybody wants Peyton Manning. Well, there's a ton of Ryan Leafs and Achilles Smiths and a numerous other that couldn't even make it. So for us to all just assume that Lawrence Taylor and Deion Sanders and Barry Sanders and Derek Thomas all just grow on trees, they don't. It doesn't just snap your fingers. So A.J. Hawk gets blasphemized a little bit because he wasn't Ray Lewis. Well, you know what? He still had a really good career, and he helped be a big part of a team that won a championship, which, by the way, we haven't had one in 15 years here. So I just think a lot of times we get caught up. Expectations are a part of this whole deal, no question. But we always kind of drag this down, and we'll look at it and say, well, I don't know, he didn't live up to the expectations that, you know, you had for a fifth overall pick. Yeah, I can understand your point on it, but... he's going to be a Packer Hall of Famer. He has the most tackles in the history of the league, and he's a captain on a Super Bowl champion team. That's a pretty damn good resume.
It is. I'm not disagreeing with you. My expectations are higher, just like my expectations are higher for Gina Della than they are for some of these fly-by-night window companies. Yeah, hey, they put in 25 windows into my house. They're not high quality like Gina Della, who has been doing some things.
Looking sleek. Looking luxurious, just like these new windows. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with the brand new windows from Pella, Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Luxurious look, sleek design, just like Gina, and custom colors available is guaranteed to give your home that extra pop to entertain and to keep you comfortable. It's the best of both worlds. Plus, getting that perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, 0% interest for up to 36 months. You don't have any down payments, no interest, no payments for up to 18 months if you book by April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
I have before me a list of fifth overall picks in NFL history. We'll go through a few of them. And Tausch is right. Some were great players and might be Hall of Fame players.
I also kind of want to do this, Jason. Jesse, throw this up for later in the show. The last 15 first, I want to rank the Green Bay Packers' last 15 first-round picks. Tier it.
We got 3 weeks till the draft. That's a great idea. I'm not sure we need to do it today, but I love the idea. I will give you our fifth overall picks next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Since J&K Security Solutions opened in 1987, our attention to detail and customer service have been our strongest assets. I'm President Jeffrey Beckman. We'll always do our best to find the most efficient and cost-effective solution to every job we tackle. Whether it's security for your home or business, installing video surveillance, or being able to control your garage doors from your phone, we can help you feel empowered with simple and user-friendly technology. Let's work together to secure your home or business. JKSecurity.com.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
Breaking news on ESPN Madison is presented by Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or visit MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Step into nostalgia with the Miller High Life Dive Bar of the Week. Listen to Rutledge and Hamilton every Thursday, and we will let you know where you can enjoy $2 Miller High Lifes. To celebrate our love for dive bars, me and Matt are going to tell you about some of our favorites, featuring one extra special dive bar that will have $2 High Lifes on special for the week. Taste the champagne of beer in its natural environment. A delightfully different dive bar in Wisconsin, like Rip's Bar in Wanakee, Paul's Neighborhood Bar, Villa Tap, and Nitty Gritty in Sun Prairie.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
It's official. 2023 was the biggest jackpot year on record at Ho-Chunk Gaming Madison. Check out these totals. We had over 57,000 jackpots and more than $134 million in winnings. This shatters our previous record year, and we have no intention of stopping here. And with our 95% average payout, we continue to be the official home of the big win right here in Madison. Let's keep it going in 2024 with even more jackpots at
Ho-Chunk Gaming Madison.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Hey, it's Alex Strofe. Stay in the know on area high school sports and follow ESPN Madison on Twitter for Prep Mania on Deck, each week's preview of the top games and events. Prep Mania on Deck is brought to you by Zimbrick Honda, a proud supporter of high school sports and local communities.
From the preps,
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros,
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Switch on the sky and the stars glow for you. Go see the world, cause it's all so brand new. Don't close your eyes, cause your future's ready to shine. It's just a matter of time before we learn.
All right, I want to make sure that I am not going to get a voicemail from AJ Hawk like you did from Mel Kiper saying I'm besmirching his career. And he told him, Wildy's trash in your career.
No. Quick question for you, because you said the other day, oh, it's nice when people ask me questions on the show rather than me. Mm-hmm. Always.
It is nice.
Trust me. Is AJ Hawk a bust? When you factor in 50 expectations.
No, he's not a bust. He's definitely not a bust.
Okay.
I have some busts.
How do you describe him?
He didn't live up to his draft status, but he was still a good NFL player. That's how I describe him. Don't you think that's fair?
Was his career a disappointment to Packer fans with the expectations of the fifth overall pick?
I think there are Packers fans who definitely feel that way.
No, I'm asking you, Jason Wilde.
It again,
are you letting your friendship cloud your judgment?
I might be a little bit.
It seems like you're leaning heavy the other way.
Here's my thing.
How it feels.
And the reason why I would argue that his career is not a bust, because that is a loaded word, right? The Mike Mamulas of the world are busts, right? There's plenty of guys that qualify as busts that just never did jack. And they were just...
John Michaels.
Right. John Michaels is undeniably a bust. He was terrible. Nice man. Now he's a doctor.
Tony Mandridge.
Yeah.
Tony Mandridge,
so,
a bust.
So that word is loaded, and he is definitely not that. But when I say that he didn't live up to draft expectations, again, fifth overall pick, you expect more than what you got. Four forced fumbles, 13 total turnover plays in 9 seasons. You want him to be a field tilter. He was a great teammate, a great leader, a great tackler. He wasn't a field tilter. He wasn't Nick Collins. He wasn't Charles Woodson. Right?
Well, nobody's who's arguing that he was Charles Woodson?
No one. I'm saying that's what you're hoping for.
At what round do we not care if you pan out?
If I get AJ Hawk at 28, I think he's lived up to expectations. It's a top 5 pick. Top 5. That's why I'm saying.
So what round do we not care? Like, oh, that guy, well, he's a 4th round pick. Oh, it'd have been great if he panned out, but we don't really care. Is it 4? Is it 5? Because 7th round pick, if I didn't play a snap in the NFL, nobody'd give a rip.
Yep, that's
right?
True.
Nobody would care. If you're a 6th round pick, I don't think anybody really cares
these days.
I think if you're a 5th round pick, you start, well, at least make a special teams, at least hang out for a year or two.
Sure.
Because it gets to be that 4th and 5th round pick is where I think we look at it from a fan standpoint and said, he didn't do anything. 7th round picks, whatever. 6th round picks, eh.
Mm-hmm.
I think you can be a bust probably all the way up to a 4th round pick. I think 5th is the line of demarcation. That goes either way.
I would say rounds 1 through 3. First 2 days as it is now, right? If you pick, like, Amari Rodgers is a bust, right?
Yep.
As a 3rd round pick. I mean, that's just the reality, right? Brian Brohm is a 2nd round pick in 08, was a bust. It wasn't a top 10 pick. He really would have been. But generally speaking, I would say, and again, my point is, if A.J. Hawk is picked at 26, I'm perfectly happy with him. And he's still a first-rounder. But top 5 is different. Let me give you some of the 5th overall picks in history, because some are Hall of Fame-level players, and some are definitely not.
Let's say this. We say A.J. Hawk or this person. Who would you rather have at the 5th pick?
I love that idea. Okay.
All right. Let's do it.
There's a couple. I don't want to do 30 players, so I'm going to pick my spots here. Okay.
Thank you for your service.
Yeah, but there's a couple that are funny. Like for the Bears in 1998, the 5th overall pick was Curtis Enos, running back, Penn State. Yes. In 1999, the Saints picked Ricky Williams.
Ricky Williams.
In 2001, the Chargers picked LaDainian Tomlinson.
I'll take LT.
Ooh.
I would take LT over AJ.
In 2004, the Redskins, at the time, took Sean Taylor.
How many years? Sean Taylor was great. I'm trying to remember what year he passed.
Yeah, I'd have to look that up.
Okay.
But he was a great player. I mean, he was a great player.
He was really good.
Yeah. He was a great player. Now, in 2005, the year before A.J. Hawk, Cadillac Williams, the running back from Auburn, went to Tampa Bay.
A.J. Hawk.
I agree.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, there's some others in here.
So, Jesse, are you keeping tabs? What are we, 3 for 6 right now?
Yeah.
50%.
50-50 right
probably
now.
Probably should have told him to keep track.
I'll get the whiteboard.
All right, a couple more. 2009, quarterback from USC, selected by the Jets, Mark Sanchez.
A.J. Hawk.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
All day.
2011, LSU.
Who's a better broadcaster, though? Sanchez or A.J. Hawk?
That's fair. A.J. Hawk is really good in his limited opportunities to speak on the Pat McAfee Show. In 2011, out of LSU, the Cardinals selected Patrick Peterson, cornerback.
Petey.
Yeah. A couple more. In 2014, the Raiders selected a linebacker out of Buffalo by the name of Khalil Mack.
Yeah.
If A.J. Hawk had been Khalil Mack, we would not be having this conversation. Last two in more recent years, the Broncos in 2018 selected Bradley Chubb, defensive end, North Carolina State.
Give me A.J. Hawk over Chubb.
Now What has Chubb done? He went to Miami in a trade, so they didn't even keep him.
He's been somewhat impactful, but consistency, not even in the same league as AJ.
Bradley Chubb, for his career, has had 39.5 sacks.
Dude, AJ almost had that many.
He had 19, yes. All right, last one.
He's a middle linebacker. Chubb's an outside rush guy.
Yep,
so,
you're right. Okay. No doubt.
Tausch, you got a squeaker at your house?
No, that's Sadie's down here. I'm sorry. All right, actually, last. Oh, man. Okay, he's going to have a tough time with the last couple of them that I have here. I'll give you just all three of them right at once. Jalen Ramsey, Tua Tagovailoa, Jamar Chase.
Chase, I'm taking over, AJ. Mm-hmm. Tua, I am not. I think Tua's going to end up being more in a Daniel Jones scenario.
I think
it's going to be more problems than it's worth. Uh-huh. And then
Jalen Ramsey, who was the best corner in the league for a period. And then
you got to say Jalen Ramsey.
I'm not biased beyond belief here. I'm being fair with this whole thing.
I think you are. I think
you're
doing a great
job. But it's not like it's some runaway freight train. Jalen Ramsey's been good.
Right.
Davante Adams ate his lunch. I can tell you that a couple of years ago in a postseason game. It was lunch-eating time.
Lunchy. Yeah.
So that's my point when Jesse puts that up, 7-6.
Exactly.
To six.
Mm-hmm.
And
exactly.
We all look at it like it was some just, oh, my God, oh, you could have. Who else could you pick? There's always going to be somebody
right.
That you
Vernon
could look
Davis.
Back in hindsight.
Vernon Davis was the next pick to the 49ers.
I'd have AJ over Vernon Davis still.
Okay. Vernon Davis did not have a great career either, but he played a position that maybe you could make the argument was more impactful.
If you asked AJ Hawk if he had a great career, would he say yes or no?
Vernon Davis played 14 years for the 49ers. He had 63 career touchdown catches. Maybe we don't think Vernon Davis is as good as he actually was.
He was pretty
Vernon
good,
Davis
I thought.
Vernon Davis a good player.
Yeah.
But you
he
would still take
player.
Hawk yeah, over him.
I think Vernon Davis is the A.J. Hawk of top six picks as tight ends.
That's actually a pretty good line.
Eric Ebron, I would take A.J. Hawk over. I can assure you of that. And Eric Ebron was one of those top picks.
All right, well, we crack open a Coors Light and raise a glass.
And Homer just texted me. He's not even in the Packer Hall of Fame. A.J. Hawk, I will assure you, will be a Packer
yes,
Hall of Fame.
Yes, he'll get in before our friend Brian Bulaga, I would think. And then Brian Bulaga will get in,
And we'll
too.
Crack open a Coors Light when both get in. Coors Light brewed to the three-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and it is cold packaged, so it's made to chill the mountains. On Coors Light's cold-activated bottles and cans, they turn blue. That's when you know it's chilled to perfection. That's why it is Coors Light in my hand. When I need a moment to chill, celebrate responsibly. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
We got trivia coming up, but before we do that, interesting clip that Jesse found from Kevin Clark's podcast with Matt LaFleur. We'll get to that next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Saturday on ESPN Radio. Mookie Betts, Shohei Ohtani, and the Los Angeles Dodgers storm into Wrigley Field for a showdown with Cody Bellinger and the Chicago Cubs. Coverage begins Saturday at 3:30 Eastern on ESPN Radio. Presented by Progressive Insurance.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Time to plunge into the ice-cold take of the week. Brought to you by Patio Pleasures. Here's Mark Tauscher.
Stephen A. believes the Knicks are the biggest threat to the Celtics in the East.
Yeah, Stephen A. is a New York guy, so I think he's always going to be biased in that regard. But the Boston Celtics are the cream of the crop right now when it comes to the Eastern Conference. But I wouldn't sleep on the Bucks. Doc's got his team moving. I think that's going to be an incredibly ice-cold take, much like my legs are feeling right now.
Patio Pleasures, your place for cold plunges, hot tubs, and outdoor living needs. Visit patio-pleasures.com.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer and get started on your fitness journey today at PrincetonClub.net. That's PrincetonClub.net.
Hi, this is Lee, inviting you to Ruth's Chris Steakhouse in Middleton. We got a great happy hour every day of the week from 4 o'clock to 7, and our patio during the summer is open too. If you're getting married, special occasion, a birthday, anniversary, or even a business meeting, we've got all the accommodations right here at Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. You work hard, and sometimes you're not sure what you want to do, where you want to spend your money. I want to encourage you to come into Ruth's Chris Steakhouse and say hello. It'd be a pleasure to meet you.
The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame, Dollar, Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokounmpo sits down with special guests on Thanalysis Show.
Fantastic.
Find Thanalysis Show on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts. And on YouTube by searching Thanalysis Show.
Attention, business owners and executives. Looking for a bank that's invested in your community as you are? Look no further than Starion Bank. As a Dane County community bank, Starion offers competitive deposit and loan rates while actively supporting local initiatives. Visit a business banker at one of our convenient branches in Middleton, Monona, and Sun Prairie. Starion Bank, full-service business banking, lending, and cash management.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
After a serious crash with a semi-truck, everything can change instantly. Your future, your family's future, your quality of life. That's why knowledge and results matter in big truck cases. And not all law firms have the know-how or the resources to handle these complicated cases. At Grunberg Law Offices, we have the experience it takes to make sure you're protected. And there's never a fee until we win your case. Grunberg Law Offices. One call, that's all.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
I remember the nights when we were young, dumb, and wild and free. When I closed my eyes, I could see you in my sweatshirt. Dancing around that college bar. These days I don't know where you are, but I get to...
I think we should have AJ on next week. A, I really enjoy talking to him. B, as long as you promise not to paint me as some sort of hater, I think it would be fun to have him because we haven't talked to him in a while.
Do you want me to keep this whiteboard ready for when he comes on?
AJ, would you have taken Vernon Davis over you?
Jalen Ramsey or you?
Jason, in fairness to you, the expectation game is a thing. There's no doubt about that, but my point back is there can be really good, solid players that you pick in the top 15, and they don't need to be Hall of Famers. Can you still have some disappointment that maybe there's somebody else you could have taken? Sure. But I think so many times and so many Packer fans look at it and say, well, with all the things AJ didn't do, and it's fair.
Yep.
You mentioned it. Forced fumbles, impact play, all that stuff. But there's also a lot of things he did do. And I think a lot of times that gets left. That is part of the price of getting that big fat bonus and having that is you have a lot more scrutiny on you. So there's give and a take, but I just want to – it's real easy to sit and say, oh, disappointment, bust, whatever you want, however you want to phrase it, but there's still – he's a good, solid player. He would have been a great pick if he was a third-round pick. Since he was number five overall, you could say, okay, I can understand why people are a little bit less than enthused by how that played out.
Like, is Alex Smith as the number one overall pick in 2005 does not live up to that status. But if you got him at the end of the first round and he had the career that he had, which wasn't as great as Aaron Rodgers by any stretch, but was certainly better than, who was the Auburn quarterback, Campbell, that went in that draft as well, Jason Campbell. I mean, he had a decent NFL career, but the expectation game for Alex Smith is, you were the number one overall pick, you need to be Peyton Manning. And he wasn't. All right, so Kevin Clark is one of the national types that I have the utmost respect for. He's so smart and has such fun ideas that when he does his podcasts, I like to listen to them because they're not just your run-of-the-mill national guy doing an interview. So he asks unique questions. Whether or not this one qualifies as unique, I'm not sure, but the answer is fantastic. Here are Kevin Clark and Matt LaFleur at the NFL meetings.
Biggest difference between the 2023 pack and the 2024 pack will be what?
I just think how we manage our own expectations, getting our guys. We had a really young team last year. I think we exceeded a lot of people's belief in what we could do. But, you know, I've been in this game for a long time now, and nothing's going to be given to you. So our guys are going to have to come back with the right mentality and just get to work. You know, get to work. How our ability to come together as a team is going to be critical, and making sure that our guys take that next step, each individual, so our collective group can be better.
Yeah, my point was there that when he asked who was the biggest badass you ever had on your team, and he said Aaron Jones, that was the kind of question I enjoyed. This answer is lame.
Yeah.
But it is also illustrative of what Tausch has always taught us, that coaches don't just talk to the interviewer or to fans when they answer questions. This has been the theme of the offseason from literally the day after they lost to the 49ers. Right? We exceeded everyone's expectations, which, by the way, you also exceeded your general manager and your head coach's expectations, if we're being honest. Right?
And sixth-round pick. This last season was a sixth-round pick.
Yes, and it went to the Pro Bowl and deep in the playoffs. And yep. Now, I think, and I'm not saying they're scared, but I think there's a nervousness bubbling underneath.
Heavy is the crown.
A nervousness
yet.
Among the coach, the general manager, and others, that a bunch of young guys that tasted a lot of success when no one had much expectation are thinking with their chests puffed out, we're the bee's knees, baby. And I think that they are doing everything they can, Tausch, to inoculate this team and just beat into their heads, hey, you guys haven't done jack. You haven't done anything.
Yeah, it's the, you don't want your team to ever be fat and happy. As Jim Harbaugh said in his little speech out with the Chargers, you know, fat is the enemy of speed. You want your team flying forward, and when you have the success that this group had, everybody is going to be, just look at all the coverage.
Mm-hmm.
That every Green Bay Packer has when they're out at the owners' meetings or just players doing local stuff back in their hometowns or whatever it is, everybody's excited because we should be. But there's coaches kind of like having, just like when they play a great game, but there's a couple of mistakes, that's the coach's dream. So there's a couple of things that I can hammer my guys on and keep them grounded. You don't want it to be, you know, everything is just running smoothly. You always want to have a couple of things that you can lean on to keep that edge. Because just like it's great when you have a really good group of dudes and everybody telling you that they're not that great, and people are saying, well, we're going to stick it up your blank. There's a reason Michael Jordan was always looking for slights. digging into the deepest crevices of everywhere to try to find a slight that he could utilize to motivate himself. And when you're a team like this, where you haven't done jack, and and everybody is kind of already crowning you,
mm-hmm.
you want to make sure because a lot of these guys don't understand yet. Last year was a free roll. There ain't many free rolls in this league, especially when you're a Green Bay Packer. I said last year, this will be the first year in a long time that the expectations, fans weren't going to be mad if we didn't make the playoffs.
Mm-hmm.
But if there was a showing that you're getting better and better. Well, now you sped it up, and I think the coaching staff and Goody, everybody is looking at it like, were we ready for this? Because you're going to be thrown into the mix. You're going to have primetime games littered everywhere. Everybody wants to see, all right, where are you at now?
Mm-hmm.
And are those players going to be ready for it? And the coaches are also wondering, are we going to be ready for it? Because it's a whole different animal when you're the hunter compared to being the hunted. Everybody wants to be that way.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody wants to be we're the up-and-coming, we're the young. And they're going to continue to try to spin it. But the bottom line is they've elevated themselves now into that top three conversation in the NFC. And everybody is going to be looking at them in a way that they looked at when Aaron Rodgers was the quarterback. And that is heavy is the crown. And you have to be ready to take everybody's best shot. Last year, I don't think that was the case until later in the season.
Was there ever a point during your career where you faced this type of, hey, yeah, you guys did some good things, but you're not the hot stuff that you think you are, and the coaches had to do this? I mean, you played with Favre and Rodgers most of the time.
No, it never came to fruition because, as I've told you and everybody else numerous times, the best thing about having that guy is you never have any doubts.
Right?
Last year, there were doubts. There were a ton of doubts by everybody.
Lots of them.
Luckily, the players are young enough that they didn't know any better, and they hadn't been through it. Veteran players that have been with, you know, veteran quarterbacks that are really good, you don't have those doubts. Now, you're going to get slapped around. You're going to get beaten down a little bit. You'll have to bounce back. But, no, there is always that expectation. And, by the way, that's a healthy thing.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to be in a position where every year is, well, this is the year that we can finally elevate ourselves. The reason we're Title Town and the reason the Packers are the Packers is the expectations are bigly. And it's a very big burden that you carry, but it's so much better than being junk and being at the bottom and, oh, maybe we can get it right this year in the draft. Or maybe we can do this. You don't want that. And the way the Packers have been able to maneuver and get to a position where they didn't have really any stretch outside of September and October of last year that was ever the case?
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty unbelievable.
All right, we need to play trivia. And while I like to manage the expectation game, I have to say Jesse's jokey answer in the first question I read ahead is really funny. Like, I actually muted my mic because I laughed out loud by it. And that, in fairness, doesn't happen every time.
There is no way this lives up to it now. Thanks for that.
I thought it was hilarious. But I'm a sucker for a good dad joke.
I hope whoever is our caller then jumps in and preempts it. I hope that there's a preemption then, if it's this good.
I think the structure will prevent that from being an issue as well, so that's good.
Interesting.
All right, so okay. Tausch is going to tell you about Fortrea in a second. I'm going to ask you to be caller 10 right now, caller 10 for Wilde and Tausch trivia. Although it is Final Four Friday trivia, I should have taken caller 4 again, but I'll take caller 10, 844-770-3776, 844-770-3776. 76. That was nice. If you're watching on the video stream, you got a nice little preview of Hunter Vaughn and the Badgers Outsider chatting it up, chopping it up inside the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios. Caller 10 right now, 844-770-3776. Tausch, tell us about Fortrea.
If you're looking for a little extra cash, you just got done with a very expensive spring break trip. Whatever it might be, Fortrea has you covered. Right now they have a couple of studies. Healthy men and women of non-childbearing potential, ages 18 to 60. Body mass index between 18.5 and 30. Study involves one stay, 11 nights, plus two follow-ups. You can make yourself $5,302 for your time and participation. Another study, healthy males and females of non-childbearing potential, ages 18 to 65. BMI of 18 to 35. This study involves one stay of four nights with three follow-ups. Grab yourself $4,430 for your time and participation. Head to FortreaClinicalTrials.com. That's Fortrea, F-O-R-T-R-E-A, clinicaltrials.com.
Caller 10 for trivia, 844-770-3776. We'll play next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Medicine everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Medicine. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here, and it's another Feel Good Friday on Wilde and Tausch, painted by Holm and Lindsay Paints. Baseball is back in full swing, and you know what that means. It's also time to get ready to tackle all those spring projects around the house. If that includes painting, I encourage you to do what my family did and get connected with the pro painters at Holm and Lindsay. It's super easy. Stop into one of the many Holm and Lindsay locations around the Madison area, and the friendly staff will help you connect with the right pros to help complete your project. And remember, Wisconsin's best painters use Wisconsin's best paint, and Wisconsin's best painters are the pro painters at Holm and Lindsay Paints. Check them out at HolmandLindsay.com. That's HolmandLindsay.com. Holm and Lindsay, great paint, great people. Stay tuned for Feel Good Friday, coming up to close out today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, painted by Holm and Lindsay Paints.
You, rah, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by your Badgerland Chevy dealers, proud supporters of Badger Athletics. Go to BadgerlandChevy.com. According to a report Wednesday in The Athletic, college presidents and top executives have devised a super league to change college football, as they believe the current system is doomed and headed for bankruptcy. According to Andrew Marchand, former Wisconsin football player Mark Tauscher joined Rutledge and Hamilton on ESPN Wisconsin to react to the news.
It's unlimited free agency. That system is not going to be tenable for a vast majority of these college programs, and I think everybody sees that.
Find the full conversation with Tauscher on Wisconsin On Demand or wherever you get your podcasts.
Badger Minutes on ESPN Wisconsin are brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Schedule an appointment online today at PellaWI.com.
LabCorp Clinical Trials is changing to a new name, Fortrea. While the name may be different, Fortrea combines decades of great experience and professionalism with new opportunities for clinical trial participation. It's more than a mission and more than a new name. Fortrea is dedicated to moving healthcare forward. To learn more about the future of healthcare and upcoming clinical trials, visit us at FortreaClinicalTrials.com. That's F-O-R-T-R-E-A, ClinicalTrials.com.
Cousin Subs was founded in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1972 and has been a member of the Madison community for decades. This year, Cousins has expanded their footprint in the Madison area by opening new locations in Stoughton and Sun Prairie, in addition to existing locations on East Washington Avenue, Monona, and Lodi. Order your favorite subs online or via our app for delivery or pickup. Eat in or grab them to go through our drive-thru for a better sub experience. Cousin Subs, we believe in better.
It's Chevy truck season, and there's no better time to do what you do best. No better time to get the job done in a Chevy Silverado with best-in-class standard torque and a Turbomax engine with a 5-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty that outlasts both Ford and Ram. So kick off whatever your thing is season right, because it all starts with a Chevy truck.
See your Badgerland Chevy dealer today.
Based on latest competitive data, excludes other GM vehicles, whichever comes first. See dealer for limited warranty details based on Ford and Ram 5-year, 60,000-mile warranty on gasoline engines.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. When you're ready to get out and prep your yard for spring, we get you the right products at the right prices. Right now, rewards members get a free $15 gift card with a $100 purchase of Scotts products. Save $10 on select 20-pound bags of Estate grass seed, $59.99, 15% off assorted long field spring bulbs, and all Livingston vegetable and flower seeds, 25% off MSRP. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Hey, it's Hunter Vaughn. ESPN Madison and Zimbrick Honda are celebrating the area's best high school sports stories with the Game Changers of the Month. Follow ESPN Madison on social media to see teams making an impact in their community. Nominate your local team today at ESPNMadisonGameChangers.com.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
Let's play some trivia.
Let's go.
Final four trivia. And we'll see if answer number three and question number one lives up to my advanced billing. Let's welcome in our contestant. It is Brian in Madison. Brian, good morning. How are you today?
Good. I'm awesome. How about you?
I'm good and awesome as well. We'll see how awesome question one is when Tausch reads it right now.
Okay, I'm going to see if I laugh like Jason did. According to ESPN Bet, which of these is true about UConn's teams in the Final Four this weekend? Only the UConn men are favored in their Final Four game.
You're smiling already. I see it.
Only the UConn women are favored in their Final Four game. Or only UConn prevent forest fires.
Right?
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Well done.
And Brian's answer is C. Only you can.
And he'd be right. Would he not be right?
I would be right.
That is not true according to ESPN Bet.
According to ESPN Bet, it is the men's team.
Jesse, you had nothing
That's
to
good,
worry
Jesse.
About. I could judge humor. That was really funny. Well done.
I'm going to walk off for the week now. I'm not going to contribute anything more.
Bring in Hunter Vaughn for the rest of the show.
Go to the righty. I struck out the side. We're good.
All right, Brian, question number two is this. Which team competing in either the men's or women's Final Four this weekend features a head coach who grew up in and played high school basketball in Watertown, Wisconsin? Is it the Alabama men's team? Is it the Iowa women's team? Or is it the NC State women's team?
Could you repeat that question? Or the answers?
I would love to do it all. Which team in either men or women's Final Four action this weekend has a head coach who's from Watertown, Wisconsin? Is it the Alabama men, the Iowa women, or the NC State women?
I believe the Alabama men.
Nate Oates, no relation to Tom, is indeed correct.
You Nate sure Oates. Tommy's not related to Nate?
Different spelling, actually. There's no E
really,
and Oates.
Really smart sports minds for both. All right, last one. Which of these teams is traveling the greatest distance from their college campus to arrive at their location for the Final Four this weekend? Is it the UConn men, the South Carolina women, or the North Carolina State men?
UConn men.
And with some travel trouble to boots. Brian, 3 for 3. You've got 4 entries into our drawing a little bit later in the show. And remember, only UConn prevent forest fires. Thanks for playing, buddy. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
Lived up to the billing, didn't
it? Yeah. It was fantastic. It was really.
You were starting to laugh before you even got to it. It was great.
Well, you gave me a little primer, and it lived up to the hype, which was good.
All right. Well, we'll see. Someone who always lives up to the hype, of course, is our good friend, the Badgers Outsider, who is in studio today to talk with us. It is his farewell appearance for the year. I mean, I guess I can't guarantee that he'll be back next season. That's not my call, but I certainly would vote very strongly in favor of that, much like I would vote him into the Reedsburg Hall of Fame, but I don't have any pull there either. Where I do have a little bit of pull is at Steinhoffel's. Great people there, great company, great partner, and right now it is the out with the old and in with the new sale during Steinhoffel's new for spring 3-day sale. You get $200 off when you spend over $2,999, or you can take advantage of Steinhoffel's limited time 60-month 0% financing when you spend over $2,999. That's 0%. I only know one other person that's been doing 0% lately. Plus, you'll get free in-stock furniture delivery when you purchase a mattress of $998 or more. Steinhoffel's has something for every single style and every single budget. So shop in-store or online at steinhoffels.com. Derek Blakesley, the Badgers Outsider, says not goodbye, but see you next time. Next, it's Wilde and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
Hey, this is Craig Karmazin. Join Kyle Wallace and me every Sunday morning for Sunday Karma on a Good Karma Brands radio station, 100.5 ESPN, WTLX, Monona, Madison.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison and streamers everywhere. I'm Jesse Nelson, Sports Center, brought to you by Goodman's Jewelers, the diamond store of Madison for generations. Check them out, 220 State Street and online at goodmansjewelers.com. A busy night tonight in the city of Milwaukee. Couple of games going on. First, the Milwaukee Bucks host the Toronto Raptors at Fiserv Forum. Tip time set for 7 o'clock. Pregame coverage starts at 6:30 right here on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5. ESPN. The Bucks listed as 15-point favorites for tonight's game, according to ESPN Bet, looking to snap their losing skid, including back-to-back games earlier this week against the Wizards and Grizzlies. Entering play today, the Bucks still sitting in the number two position in the Eastern Conference playoff picture. The Boston Celtics have clinched the number one overall seed. Meanwhile, American Family Field hosts the three games this weekend as the Brewers welcome the Seattle Mariners for a weekend set. First pitch tonight set for 7:10. Opening day starter Freddie Peralta on the mound for Milwaukee. In Cleveland tonight, the NCAA Women's Final Four gets underway on ESPN at 6 o'clock. North Carolina State and South Carolina. And then the main event at 8:30. UConn and Caitlin Clark in Iowa. Watch it on ESPN and the ESPN app.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Derek Blakesley. And like they say at Quick Trip, it's not goodbye. We'll see you next time. Our Badgers Outsider presented by PDS.
Indeed, PDS have been providing technology solutions and transforming IT career companies for over 30 years. PDS is giving today's worker the true ability
to work from anywhere as they balance work and life. PDS wants to be your trusted partner in driving success with enterprise solutions, digital workplace platforms, and managed services that fit your needs. PDS, Paragon Development Systems.
He is the AJ Hawk of our little show here. Consistent, solid, a leader, a captain. Not really much of a playmaker, though. It is Derek Blakeslee on Wilde and Tausch. Derek, good morning. How are you?
Just a disappointment in general, though, for my draft.
No, you're a great teammate. You're very solid.
You know, I came in the lobby today, and I thought maybe there'd be a little reception for me as I close out the season and in the year. Actually, Mel Kiper down there just pacing back and forth, wondering why. It actually had his hair combed forward, just completely out of sorts after the way he was treated by Tausch. So hoping to
yeah, it was bad.
Hoping to bring a little more.
You've been there.
Hoping to bring a little more righteousness back into the show. We've attacked AJ Hawk. We've hurt Mel Kiper's feelings to the point that he had to go to the Smithsonian and dig through 40 years of draft coverage in order to validate that he hadn't forgot about our good friend out of the farmlands of Auburndale. A high motor guy out of the farm fields of Auburndale.
Well, I can't wait till Jen gets that guide delivered to her home and she can share the assessment with us. Or I have to allow for the possibility that Tausch will turn out to be right, but I think the odds of that are pretty low. Hey, are you excited for the Super League? Were you involved in these conversations at all per The Athletic?
No, but we talked about I feel like, and to Tausch's credit, to your credit, we've talked about this stuff for like 3 or 4 years, what was going to happen. And the idea of a Super League and the stuff is so dumb because what was really cool about college sports was the idea that you had people that were like students at these institutions. You were preparing them to go out and be in the financial industry or doctors or lawyers or whatever, artists. And for the most part, they participated in sports and that became a big thing for some of them. And I always thought two things could be right at the same time, which was they deserve compensation for drawing 100,000 people into a stadium. Mm-hmm. They deserve to be compensated because 17,000 will fill a basketball arena to come watch what they do. But there was no reason in this 3 to 4 years we talked about stuff that we talked about leading up to a Super League. We talked about these two-year contracts that will probably be coming. And nobody that was trusted with the sports and the NCAA and the people that were supposed to hold up the structures and care, they didn't do anything. They just throw their hands up in the air and they cried like babies and they tried to fight what was an impossible fights in the courts. Mm-hmm. But this is how we do things in America. That's why we have corporate law. We litigate. And we could have litigated all sorts of policy changes and parameters and rules. And there's nothing was done. And money ruled the day, and here we are now talking mm-hmm. about super leagues with an inferior, let's face it, is what it is. It's inferior talent to what we have in professional sports with less rules, less structure, and unfortunate criticism of really good people on the coaching staffs for these teams and people that work within the actual athletic departments. And it's just not fair to them to be in this Wild West environment for this long. So I'm very frustrated with it.
Yeah, the problem was you never had anybody with any vision and to proactively do something. Instead, you fought because the system was so good for so many for so long, and mm-hmm. they thought, you know what, we'll run this clock out, and then when it implodes, because everybody knew the Ed O'Bannon stuff was going to implode this thing.
Yeah,
and nobody did anything about it. And you still, I don't know how this is all going to shake out, because this isn't as easy as just saying there are charters signed with conferences. There are Title IX ramifications. There are other athletic there's just so much there. I don't know. I don't think it's going to be as easy as just saying, all right, 80 schools, we're just going to go break off, play football, everybody else go do your thing. I don't think it's going to be that easy.
No, it's not. But even I think about the conversations we had where I remember a show where I was like, Jason, the reality here is that Alabama, and this is football we were talking, Alabama, Florida, Texas A&M, they should just break off and do their own thing, and then the rest of us can just go back and have college football, and I don't think we'd miss them. Mm-hmm. And we all said it, but in my own mind, and you guys, you just dismissed it. You're like, well, that's stupid. You're not just going to break off and. But if you really sat down and went through a thought chart about logically what was going to happen, this is where we were going to end up. I mean, people, smaller schools are going to run out of money. Parts of the country that don't care as much about a particular sport, they're not going to invest more money if they're still. So you only have a finite number of people that want to be in that pool. But if everybody doesn't play, it ruins a lot of the storylines. It messes up the policies and leads to what Tausch just said, is now we're mired again in muck, and we've already been 2 or 3 years in it, and the effects it's having. Let's just get outside the box. The mental health from people trying to coach these teams or trying to keep all this stuff together, athletic directors trying to, these people got to go home at night and try to figure out how they're going to navigate this. And you have people in Jason's role that it's their job to ask questions. And there's no answers for some of these questions because none of the people that were supposed to be the gatekeepers of the integrity of it did their job. Mark Emmert and his ilk, they were all in the last quarter of their careers. They saw the money coming. The money kept coming. And they knew they were just going to exit stage left.
Right. They're in denial. Right.
They were in denial. Not they knew they were problem. Getting the money. They don't have the pressure. They step aside and they're like, here's your mess. And all of us sitting here that love college sports are just treating coaches and stuff really unfairly. You know, especially I just don't like the way Greg's being treated. I like to criticize the coaching, the games, the performance. I don't want to criticize a guy because you didn't coddle AJ Store enough or give him $500,000 instead of $1 million. I mean, that's not what people go into coaching for. That's not even the skill set they're supposed to have. So the mess is in the leadership of people who are already left. They retired. They're gone. And there's no accountability. And it's extremely frustrating, and it's not good for anybody.
So, Jason, for everybody that's listening, can you kind of give a – because I saw a little bit of it. I'm not an athletic subscriber. Can you kind of give a layout of the 80
– You act like an athletic supporter.
What this is going to – what this is supposed to look like, because I have an idea, but where these guys are at and what they're trying to get done.
So, all right. So I think the best way to explain this is that and look, TV rules everything, right? And what we had talked about when we had this conversation with Derek was a concept where it was basically ESPN and Fox got together and, like, one had the AFC and one had the NFC, like we've had with the NFL. And they are... They're at the forefront of this. It was Andrew Marchand who is as plugged in as anybody in the world on the sports broadcasting, radio, TV, etc. landscape that wrote this in The Athletic. And university presidents are involved in it. The structure that they have discussed, which again is not, I mean, I don't know how they're going to actually get this to come to fruition. Because right now it's a concept, but look, where there's smoke, there's fire. The original idea is 7 10-team divisions with the top 70 programs in college football. And then there would be an eighth one, which would basically, and Derek, help me if I'm wrong about this, but it's kind of like they're taking the concept from European soccer
of relegation,
where you can be relegated or you can be promoted from the rest of the FBS schools into this last group of 10. So that gets you to 80. And the plan would and again, I don't know how you get there. I've seen a bunch of stories now talking about the challenges that would be part of this in terms of, as Tausch mentioned, with Title IX and all the different charters with conferences and everything else. There's 20 people involved with this. It's led by the chancellor of Syracuse, the president at West Virginia, someone inside Roger Goodell's office in the NFL, which I also think is very interesting because we know that the NFL, you can say what you want about whatever the USFL, XFL, UFL league is right now. College football is the NFL's minor league. They have a vested interest in this not getting screwed up. But this is the group. And then the playoff would be the eight division winners plus eight wild card teams. So it would be a 16-team playoff. Now, again, I don't know how that works with the Big Ten, which has, what, like 72 teams in it now? How many does the Big Ten have with the West Coast additions now?
It's a bunch.
20?
It's a bunch.
18, 20?
I think it's 17 or 18. 18 is, I think, what we're up to.
So, again, I don't know how realistic any of this is, but the fact that this is being discussed indicates to me that there is a strong, and it's not just TV networks. This is also university presidents and chancellors who are involved in this, that this is coming in some form or fashion. It may not look like they're talking about now, but it's coming. And Tausch, as someone who loves his alma mater, loves his football program, I hate to point this out, but 80 teams, that sounds great until you're part of the bottom 20 of them, because somebody's got to win the games and somebody's got to lose them. And this is not going to necessarily be great for the teams that aren't at the very top of this equation.
I would disagree. If this does get structured and you actually have rules in place with a CBA and everything else, I think this is what needs to happen. Because from our standpoint, I think we're always going to be fighting a tough uphill battle if it's about raising excess money and trying to pay AJ Store $1 million or trying to pay any of these other players all this additional money. I think if it comes down to even playing field and your operation about developing and growing players, when you get to that point, as Derek was saying, if it's a 2 or 3 year deal where you get these kids for a couple of years and you can grow and develop them, that to me is a big net plus for what we do.
Okay, so, but
what?
But
yeah,
revenue distribution would not be an even split.
It has to be. It will have to be.
It's what it says right here.
Complete bunk. Well, I'm going to tell you right now. The reason the NFL is the way it is because the New York Giants back in the 50s decided, for the betterment of everybody, it's not going to just be that we take 80% and we'll throw Green Bay 15%. It was, we need to do this, and it needs to be uniform so that this thing grows. Someone had that vision. Well, you know what? You don't even have to have that vision. Now, look, you're talking to the NFL. It can't be that Alabama's is this and
right.
UAB, if they're one of those 80. It will be collectively bargained, and it will be salary cap and everything else. It's going to have – now, that doesn't mean – that Alabama can't go and do different things, and if they spend their money wisely, they have a hidden advantage to start, but that can be caught up. But if you're saying that their salary pool is $100 million and Wisconsin's is $40 million, no, that will not be sustainable, and I don't want any part of that as a Wisconsin Badger fan.
Derek, we'll move on from this. I just want to get your thought one last thing. So the other part of this, there'll be a negotiation with a players' union on NIL, transfer portal, and salary structure rules, which I think would lead to the contractual commitments of 2 years, and then you could transfer whatever else. But again, if there's no – if there's no salary cap in this, whatever they're going to call it, NIL cap, whatever it is, if some schools out of the 80 can spend $100 million and some can spend $40 million, this isn't going to be any better.
Be like Major League Baseball.
Right. And then you got the Oakland A's playing in Sacramento.
And the other thing, guys, there's two points I want to make to close it.
One, put a bow on it. That's our phrase around here.
Then I intentionally didn't use that phrase. On purpose. Other people, Tausch has brought it up. As a person that likes sports, you can put all the structure. Rob Vogel brought it up to me about the 2 year contracts, and I agree that's where it's going. But why wouldn't I just want to watch the NFL? They're better players. It's better football. The reason I liked college sports was different than the reason I like professional sports.
Mm-hmm.
So if you take that away, what's the difference between that and the XFL or any other thing, any other farm system type of thing?
Mm.
And let me bring this back to my second point. And this is important. This is my last show, so I don't care what people think because it's not a sports thing. there, and I might be ignorant about something, I don't know, or living in
Pollyanna-ish, yes, some might say.
This idea that, like, folks from diverse economic backgrounds, so, and primarily in some of these places, African-American kids that are coming out of places where none of their family had gone to college, poor people from all over the country, wherever you come from, whatever your race, creed, ethnicity, whatever. This was your chance through athletics to get access to world-class education wherever you went, to have a sustainable improvement of your life, of your family's life. And athletics was, for many, or for some, a vehicle to help you get there. And this whatever we do or wherever this goes will work out for some for a while. But, man, when you think about people, what have we done to the young people here? And I don't blame the young player, because if I'm AJ Storr, I'm taking the $1 million when I'm 20 years old, of course. But an adult in the room has to say, it's the education they can't take from you as long term. It's the education that gives you the conduit to the jobs, to the athletic departments, into, I know, the financial jobs, do a lot of recruiting out of the Wisconsin athletic, working at the Mercantile Exchange and the Board of Trade in Chicago. And there's just a lot of folks that like to hire athletes because of what they've gone through in sports, but also what they've been trained through the classes. And I just feel like nobody gives a bleep about the kids here or the future or what this structure was to fall in love with a couple of people on your respective teams, watch them grow, watch them develop, and when they leave, they may go have a sports career, guys. They might make it. Every dream might come true for them. But that money's gone. 80% of NFL folks that play 3 years in the league, they're broke within 4 years after they leave. Is that right, Tausch? 8 out of 10?
Well, I mean, that's the stat that goes. I think it's probably improved since then. But
so even if it doesn't change the directional thing of what I'm saying. Even if everything goes your way, you're 26 or 27 years old, and 0.5% might have stability for the rest of their life, and I'll deal with all the good things that come from that and the bad things. But for everybody else, if you don't have the degree and you don't have the connections of staying and building social capital in those markets that serve you from a university standpoint, everybody that participates in these athletics, interscholastic, it's 40 years you have to work and find a way to make a living. You have to find a way to nurture those relationships to find meaningful employment. And if everyone is just a free agent and roaming around when you're 18, 19, 20 years old, and even if you make money, what is that money worth 20 years from now, 30 years? There's not the financial literacy to understand the obligations, the way inflationary pressures, and the time value of money. So we leave people where we had a system in place that would uplift people. It was a potential way to uplift people into great lives, meaningful lives, and improve the standings of their family, their future spouses, their children. And now, because everybody chased the money, it makes me feel like that's not going to work out as well as it did, because we didn't put good guardrails in place to protect people from themselves that are young, while also rewarding them because of their ability and skill level, that it draws the money and attention and eyeballs that it does. There was a happy medium, a way to go here, and it wasn't taken. So I don't want to forget, we're talking about media, we're talking about TV, we talk about money, we talk about leagues, but we don't talk enough about the young people who we've done a terrible disservice, because the educational part of this experience seems to be getting just stomped all over the place, and it makes me sick.
Amen. Should the Badgers fire Greg Gard? We'll get the Badgers outsider's opinion next.
Got to manage that portal.
It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
What does it take to make a diamond?
extreme heat and pressure, and about a billion years. But you can't wait that long. What do? You go to Goodman's Jewelers. I'm John Hayes from Goodman's Jewelers. There's a reason we are the Diamond Store of Madison. Since 1933, we provided outstanding service and selection to our customers. And that, in turn, has helped to establish countless great memories through the years. GoodmansJewelers.com, located at 220 State Street. Truly a destination worth reaching.
ESPN Madison is on Wisconsin sports. Catch up on anything you missed on the Varsity Podcast on Wisconsin On Demand. Brought to you by Zimbrick Honda, a proud supporter of Wisconsin Badger Athletics. If you're looking to purchase, finance, or service a new or pre-owned Honda, shop local, part of the Madison community since 1973.
I've been here for 28 years. I didn't know anything about trailers when I started here, and now I know a lot about trailers. I enjoy what I do very much. I like the interaction that I have with my coworkers. And the pride that you have making the trailers. You always see them going down the road and you say, hey, that blue and white sticker, I made that trailer. My name is Sue and I'm proud to be a part of Stoughton Trailers.
Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
When it comes to security for your home and family, you want a winner, and we found one when we placed our trust with J&K Security Solutions. This is Greg Gard. Kim and Jeff hit the game-winning shot for us with the Control 4 home technology system. Home or away, from our smartphones, we can open the garage door, dim the lights, turn on the TV, as well as arm the security system. That's convenience as well as peace of mind. Let J&K Security Solutions do for your home or business like they've done for us. Call 255-5799 or online at jksecurity.com.
Searching for the perfect brunch spot this weekend? Look no further than the Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company. Every Saturday and Sunday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., indulge in the Great Dane's sweet and savory brunch menu paired with mimosas, Bloody Marys, or one of their signature beers on tap. Enjoy any of their four Madison area pubs, downtown, Hilldale, Fitchburg, or East Madison. Learn more and view the full menu at greatdanepub.com/brunch. Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's original brew pub since 1994.
Since 1956, Holman Lindsay Paints has been making paint in Wisconsin for Wisconsin. Because of their commitment to making great paint for Wisconsinites, Holman Lindsay has grown over the years to 26 locations in this great state. Headquarters in Sun Prairie with a state-of-the-art facility, Holman Lindsay has the paints you need to make your job better. From do-it-yourself to professional, Holman Lindsay has paint for everyone. Visit one of their local locations today in Madison, Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Janesville.
There's a good chance if you watch sports, you're getting served information about hormone optimization. What does that even mean? Dr. Ness Rodriguez at Carbon World Health can tell you exactly what hormone optimization means. He will take your blood work and let you know if it's right for you. If you're feeling sluggish, not losing weight like you used to, you're not gaining muscle like you used to, or you just don't feel like yourself in most aspects of your life, go see Dr. Ness Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. In fact, sign up for the 6-week experience so you can see everything that Carbon World Health has to offer, including hormone optimization. Learn more at carbonworldhealth.com.
Jesse Nelson here. Join Adam Mertz and me for the grand opening of the Bogey Factory in Verona. Experience indoor virtual golf like never before, including the same state-of-the-art TrackMan technology as seen on the PGA Tour. ESPN Madison at the Bogey Factory, Saturday, April 13th from noon to 2.
The Milwaukee Bucks. The Toronto Raptors.
Giannis sees Capella between him. Oh, what a spin move. Goes right around Capella and lays it in with a foul.
Tonight on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN.
All right, Derek, that was a lot of heavy talk there, and worthwhile and well-delivered by you. And I'm not just saying that because I won't talk to you again until, like, August. Do you have anything else on your mind? This is really your, again, not farewell, but see you next time in August.
Should we have a funeral for me?
No, because you're just going. You're like Tausch. You're going on a sabbatical. You're going to Italy, but you're not coming back until the end of the summer.
Were we always able to do this? I always miss that I never get to talk to either of you. It's been months.
Well, it's not like you don't have my phone number or Tausch's. You and Tausch, don't you guys hang out? I thought you guys were friends.
Tausch is.
Oh no! Oh boy!
It's fine. He's busy. I get it.
Oh no!
I talked to Sarah. I was at Cap Ice this week, so I talked to Sarah for like a half an hour. So I think I'm better friends with Sarah now than I am with Tausch, if you just think about the actual one-on-one time. But that's fine. You know, there's other people that are better.
I'm trying to think, Derek. I've invited you golfing probably 15 times. How many times have you invited me out to your course?
You haven't invited me golfing? It's my dog. Having a 3-year-old totally puts you, as a 40-year-old puts you totally backward to where you were when you first had kids and you realized, oh, I'm going to have totally different people I hang out with. Like, and then you start to get freedom back, and Sid's getting old enough for you, Jason, where you will probably hopefully start to have a social life for yourself. I'm in no rush.
I can assure you, he will not.
It's like I took a new job. I now have a team of like 30 people. It's going to be 30 people that I do.
You supervise people
all over North America. I'm in the development of a sales academy for our larger holding company for Converge. So I've got to mentor and sit on calls and come up with curriculum to teach them how to deal with. How to have conversations with people that are 20 years older than them that don't sit on Snapchat all day. It's
wow.
There's patterns I see.
I don't want to second guess any of the corporate folks that made this decision. I'm not doing that. I'm sure you'll do a great job. You're very big on connectivity. So have you gotten like Snapchat to make yourself a little more relatable?
No, I mean I hate it so much that the biggest thing I would tell you guys is, well, I'm doing a lot of work with Tesla right now.
I love the sides everywhere sides. Yeah, the band.
They're the AI chips and some of the projects that they're doing with NVIDIA and it's scary. I have my nephews that are all that age too, and they're like Hunter. I was talking to Hunter. They're trying to save for a house, and there's big money out there, but you have to know what you're doing. Like you have to understand and be in conversations about machine learning and how you're going to work with. Outcomes and like interpret data.
Okay, so I don't want to interrupt you, but I thought we were going to make this like the fun segment, and instead, it's like the rise of the machines in Terminator, and I have to be worried about my robot turning on me like it turned on Will Smith and iRobot.
But no, we can talk about
Derek. Should Greg Gard be fired? Let me help you out here, Jason.
Thank you. I thought that's what I said at the end of the last segment.
I don't know how we AI. Got here.
I didn't even know
I'm
we were on.
I'm usually the one
while.
I talk I AI for 2 seconds, and I say I don't want to go into that because nobody gives a rip on that's listening.
No,
to this.
I think
there's plenty of AI podcasts.
I think what's interesting is Greg is supposed to be a basketball coach, right? So you're looking at
that's what they said
at what the skill set was for all of that, and. It's like it's changed. And that's kind of what happened with Paul Chris, too. And every coach is struggling with it. And can you imagine having a lower-end program, a mid-major, and you're losing all your kids all the time and the criticism that comes with that and trying to rebuild? I think he's got a year. I don't know what you guys think, but I think Greg is sitting where we know he can coach basketball. That was the question when he took over for Bo. Could he coach? Well, yeah, he can coach. And he had the team playing really well. But then team chemistry issues come up because you've got folks that sometimes are strangers probably at some, you know, and trying to get all that to work together. And the year can start to go sideways, and then attitudes are different. You might have people checked out halfway through the year. So I think that he's got to win in the portal here a little bit. And then when he gets done with that, he can go out and score. Score with the guys that are going to get the points and be able to run up and down. I don't know if you can recruit anymore and play in 50, 60-point basketball games. So we have to try to get to the athleticism, so like a Mason-Dixon line there where you're above the line to be able to not have what happened against James Madison happen, where an aggressive team that maybe not be as skilled can just come out and be more ready to play and make you look bad. So hopefully we get some players in.
Are you advising Connor Sejan on his next stop if he
Especially
hasn't
the way
chosen
we talked, already? We talked about him like he was really really loyal, and we love that about him. And then he kind of made a decision that was, I don't know, if in his best interest or if we – you never know.
He didn't play against James Madison when they couldn't hit the broadside of a barn offensively.
It'll be interesting to watch, won't it, Jason? Like,
yes.
Wherever he lands, what's he going to look like?
Yep. You and I will be watching.
He can shoot, but
the Connor Sejan fan club on Wilde and Tausch. It's two people, it's you and me.
Yeah. So You know,
Derek, are you okay? We need to move on.
Yeah.
And I feel like you've gotten more downtrodden as the as your appearance.
Just coming.
Are you sad to say goodbye? Are you gonna keep coming to the Spark Building and just sit in the lobby with the security guards?
I'm gonna miss the coming down. I think I have a lot of trepidation about when the fall rolls around, guys. What is this landscape gonna look like? What's gonna happen in the intervening months? And where are we going to be? I still see, from a football perspective, our recruiting class is where it's supposed to be. We're doing well, even though we lose people from time to time. It's just hard to analyze or have opinions or takes about stuff because you're just not sure. And that uncertainty is scary for me because I like being a college sports fan. And that's going to change. And we're going to notice it a lot more as the conference really starts to change now. We're going to be playing different teams that are going to be in our conference of 18. So it just, as you start to think through these things, it's hard to give hot takes or give answers because they're complicated. And that's what we have to sort through as fans, as people that cover the sports. That's why I bring up all these issues about data, the gambling data, all the hands that are in the cookie jar here, and the way the world's going with where I work and what I see on a daily basis in contrast or combined with what's going into athletics.
Derek, we're going to miss you. I hope you're chipper and everything that you are concerned about by the time you return to our program in August will at least have trended in a more positive direction and you feel good, you're refreshed. Enjoy all the highlights of parenting and hockey at Cap Ice Arena.
Quick Trip free samples.
Going golfing with Tausch when he...
I think I have better odds of golfing with Jesse, I think. In the upcoming,
wow, that'll be fun. You guys, yeah, stop a wow. Quick Trip on your way home afterward.
I'm
yeah,
hoping,
perfect.
I'm hoping to recap the trip to Italy with Tausch, and I'm hoping to.
That'd be fun.
It's a slideshow coming.
Maybe be
and
up
a book.
In,
yeah,
up
we'll have
Appleton
a slideshow.
And you know, yep. get a crumpet and some coffee with Jason, maybe in his basement. I don't know.
You're
where
not coming to my house, but maybe I'll see you when I'm in Madison.
I can come sit across from your front yard.
You know, I have the same security staff as the. I have the same security staff as the Spark Building. They have a picture of you. They know what to expect. Derek, we do appreciate everything all season long. We look forward to next season. Thanks, buddy.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
Tausch, tell us a little bit about AmFam. Try to bring us back up and make us happy again.
All right, calling all Packer fans. American Family Insurance wants to see you and a friend in Detroit this year for the draft. Enter the Dream Draft Day sweepstakes for the chance to win two tickets to the draft, travel and hotel accommodations to Detroit, a custom jersey, and much, much more. Go to amfam.com/Packers to learn more and to enter. That's coming up. We're only a couple weeks out from the big night.
More Wilde and Tausch straight ahead. Stick around.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
You're back at the gym. Your new gym outfit? On point. Your new sneakers? Baller. You've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with Access Checking. It's maintenance fee-free with no minimum balance requirements. So when you take your first yoga class in 10 months, your body might surprise you, but your checking account won't. You've got this with Access Checking from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
When you're in the right place at the right time, things get done. The important things, like knowing what you need and how it all works. Talking truck. Fixing it right the first time. At Zimbrick Chevrolet, our people get it done right and now. That's how you know you're in the right place at the right time. And you'll never overpay at Zimbrick Chevrolet.
Mark your calendars and get ready for game day at the 5th Annual Easter Seals Wisconsin Celebrity Basketball Experience, presented by Affiliated Dentists. Former UW athletes hit the hardwood on April 13th at Madison College to support children and adults with disabilities. Tip-off is at 3 p.m. And for some pregame action, be sure to register your kids grades 3 through 8 at the Shot Doctor Skills Academy from 1 to 2:30 with former UW men's basketball assistant coach Gary Close. All abilities welcome to register. Visit easterseals.com/gameday for more details.
Listen to Madison Money Guy every Saturday morning at 7 a.m. on 100.5 ESPN and ESPNWisconsin.com.
I like to refer to inflation as the silent killer. It's an invisible risk. It's just the idea that things get more expensive over time. You're going to need milk and eggs when you're in your early 60s and when you're in your early 80s. You're going to get a loaf of bread, and it's going to be more expensive 20 years from now.
Christian Finfrock is the Madison Money Guy. Call him today at 208-1800.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now on bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Are you looking for a fast-paced job in a fun and exciting work environment? Look no further than Ho-Chunk Gaming Madison. We offer a wide range of job and shift availability in both part-time and full-time positions. Competitive wages and great benefits await you at Ho-Chunk Gaming Madison. Visit us in person or check out our website to see all of our job openings. Make work fun and apply for a job at Madison's only casino.
Step into nostalgia with the Miller High Life Dive Bar of the Week. Listen to Rutledge and Hamilton every Thursday, and we will let you know where you can enjoy $2 Miller High Lifes. To celebrate our love for dive bars, me and Matt are going to tell you about some of our favorites, featuring one extra special dive bar that will have $2 High Lifes on special for the week. Taste the champagne of beer in its natural environment. A delightfully different dive bar in Wisconsin, like Rip's Bar in Wanakee, Paul's Neighborhood Bar, Villa Tap, and Nitty Gritty in Sun Prairie.
From the preps,
Russell spins his way into the paint with contact, finishes, and a foul.
That was pretty.
To the pros,
Beverly launches from three, and he knocks it down.
The biggest games play on 100.5 ESPN.
Slow down on Monday.
Thanks to Derek Blakeslee. We love that guy, and we look forward to next season with him and PDS. But, Tausch, I guess my question for you after our time with Derek, which was, we've had a few of these serious conversations, and I think they're important conversations to have. And I think he's right about, look at the life that you, for example, have built, right? Your parents weren't wealthy, right? And you have built an amazing life for you and your family. Because you finally got to play your last year at Wisconsin, and then you built an awesome NFL career. And so I agree with his assessment that there are kids that are being forgotten and part of this equation. And the NCAA loves its student athletes phrase, but I just see a lot of dollar signs for a group of people, several groups of people, when I look at this. Are you as concerned as Derek is, and as I am, about what we will eventually land at? Or do you think the better forces will figure out a way to not just leave the Mark Tauscher-type players behind, the walk-on who earns his way onto being a starter on a football team and doesn't enter the transfer portal because back then it didn't exist?
Yeah, I kind of disagree with both of you on that. I think there's more opportunity now than ever. And there's more opportunity to actually grow and to get a piece of the pie. And not everybody gets selected or gets the chance to go play in the NFL. You can now go to a smaller school. You can play and showcase yourself. And what you're seeing is there, some of these bigger schools now will throw some money at you to come and play at their school because you've proven yourself. Where you didn't have that mobility before, and you're getting a couple hundred grand to come play.
Yeah, but there's a bunch of kids in the transfer portal that aren't getting any of that.
But at some point, you have to play, and you have to perform. So you're still getting opportunities to go on. So I understand the initial point, well, that some of these colleges are going to look more for developed talent. But you're still going to have to go. You're going to go to smaller schools, prove that you can play and get there, rather than walk on. But there's a lot of kids that would do that anyways. Right now, if you can play and you can develop and you find a place, the world has never been better for athletes. There was such a suppression for so many years, and now there is money to be made. There's opportunities galore for all of these high school athletes that go on. Now, whether or not some of these smaller schools are going to survive, that's a question mark that it concerns me. But as we're sitting here now and how things are shaken out, it has never been a better opportunity for young football players to go grow their talent and get paid while they're in school compared to where we've ever seen it before. And obviously, if you can play, the NFL finds you and knows where you're at, and that opportunity continues as well. And yeah, you have the XFL, UFL, that whole deal. So the opportunities are everywhere if you're willing to work and to showcase yourself and maybe go through some things to prove that you can do it.
How many players on a team right now are getting money?
No clue.
Yeah, I don't either. I think that's part of the problem too, right? Like, you have no idea. You have no idea, but there are plenty of guys on these teams that aren't making money, that aren't getting a piece of the pot.
You're still getting opportunities. And, again, for me, I never should have been paid in college. Matter of fact, I paid to come to college for the first 2 years. But for the other part of it, when I was a sophomore, a junior, I wasn't playing, and I was getting a ton of great things. Now, you'd also be getting some money. That never was going to be the case back in those days. So this huge pie that keeps growing and growing and growing, players are going to start sharing in that, and that is a good thing.
Yeah, I hope you're right. I hope they're going to share from that pie.
Well, because they're going to have to.
Because that's not what they're getting right now, and that's why some are getting
aren't. That is what the crux of the conversation we started at the top of this hour. That's what this is about. Because the sustainability of asking donors and businesses, I always laughed when people, oh, just go get a car deal, and all these players are going to get all this. That's not how anyone that actually understood how it was going knew. Yeah, that's not how this works.
Mm-hmm. You're right.
It's just not. So now you're going to say, all right, CBS, NBC, ESPN, everybody is paying into the Big Ten and all this other stuff. Players are going to start getting a cut of that. That's how it should be. But
that's how it is in the NFL.
Players will be taxed on that. And that's where you hope there's good accounting firms. And there's good, because what worries me is people aren't going to know what the hell's going on and think, oh, this is just, oh, this is great. And next thing you know, guys are in the clink because they didn't pay their taxes. That's the stuff that you better start paying attention to.
Well, if you're going to get that money, make sure you put it at Associated Bank. They've got all the kinds of people that can help you with that money, make you smart about investing it, make sure you know the tax laws, all the things that you need to know. And if you're a Packers fan, or maybe a future Packer who's getting his NIL money in college and hoping that he'll be drafted into the NFL, Associated Bank is the official bank of the Packers. AssociatedBank.com/Packers. Find out more about all the great perks that come with being an Associated Bank Packers checking holder. We'll continue this conversation, or maybe we'll shift gears. Stick around to find out. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Saturday on ESPN Radio. Mookie Betts, Shohei Ohtani, and the Los Angeles Dodgers storm into Wrigley Field for a showdown with Cody Bellinger and the Chicago Cubs. Coverage begins Saturday at 3:30 Eastern on ESPN Radio. Presented by Progressive Insurance.
Mark Tauscher here for Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie, the name you can trust.
Well, it's the time of the year when everybody is thinking about travel. Whether you're still finalizing details for a spring getaway or you're already on to thinking about where you'll be heading for a summer road trip, don't let vehicle maintenance be what slows you down. Make sure your vehicle is in its best shape possible every time you're getting ready to hit the road by stopping in to see the amazing service team at Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie. Routine maintenance is critical for keeping your vehicle in the best shape possible. Oil changes, tire rotations, tune-ups, and so much more. Get it checked out before you hit the road so you're not stranded when you're away from home. And if you're in the market for a vehicle upgrade, check out Zimbrick Chevy's new and used vehicle inventory. You can start your search by logging on to ZimbrickChevrolet.com. Stop into Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie and discover this great automotive team I've been telling you about for years. Consistently recognized as a Best of Madison operation, Zimbrick Chevrolet on Main Street in Sun Prairie. The name you can trust.
You, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by Stoughton Trailers. Big trailers and big opportunity at Stoughton Trailers. Learn more about why a career at Stoughton Trailers might be for you. Go to stojobs.com. According to a report Wednesday in The Athletic, college presidents and top executives have devised a super league to change college football, as they believe the current system is doomed and headed for bankruptcy. According to Andrew Marchand, former Wisconsin football player Mark Tauscher joined Rutledge and Hamilton on ESPN Wisconsin to react to the news.
It's unlimited free agency. That system is not going to be tenable for a vast majority of these college programs, and I think everybody sees that.
Find the full conversation with Tauscher on Wisconsin On Demand or wherever you get your podcasts.
Badger Minutes on ESPN Wisconsin are brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Schedule an appointment online today at PellaWI.com.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. When you're ready to get out and prep your yard for spring, we get you the right products at the right prices. Like all-new Estate Premium 4-in-1 Lawn Treatment, $59.99, with both pre- and post-emergent crabgrass killer in one application. 36-pound bags of Estate Weed and Feed, only $34.99. And 20-pound bags of Bio-Advanced Grub Killer Plus, $29.99 after sale and mail-in rebate. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Dog, I can't remember a game that was this good.
Yeah, you know what else would be great right now? Some food from the Great Dane.
I know, but we can't go right now.
Good news! The Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company is available on DoorDash and Uber Eats. Stay in the game with the full menu delivered from the Great Dane closest to you. Downtown, Hilldale, Fitchburg, or East Madison. Order today with DoorDash and Uber Eats or on thegreatdanepub.com. Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's original brew pub since 1994.
Join Prairie Athletic Club and spring forward your membership today. Hi, this is Sarah Tauscher, encouraging you to save now until the end of August when you join the pack. The Platinum membership is everything you want and more, including Pilates, hot yoga, bar, unlimited training zone, and boot camp classes. Discover the ultimate wellness experience tailored just for you. Not a member? Not a problem. Guests are welcome daily. Head to prairieathletic.com or stop in today for all their membership specials. Prairie Athletic Club, family fun community.
From color-changing alexandrite to shimmering zircon and everything in between at Chalmers Jewelers, you'll find high-quality, affordable, one-of-a-kind pieces. We source straight from the gem cutters, and we manufacture in-house from start to finish. As the manufacturer, we believe in truth in pricing. Never pay more for quality and stunning, beautiful jewelry. She's one-of-a-kind, and so should her jewelry be. While others may send your jewelry dreams to someone else to make, with us, your dreams become reality with the help of our custom jewelers, with you involved the whole way. With a staff that has over 200 years of combined experience, why buy from a place that marks up jewelry made by the thousands? When you can buy direct from Chalmers for that one-of-a-kind piece that is better quality, often for less.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
On the air, on demand, on social, on Wisconsin sports. Serving Wisconsin sports fans. This is 100.5 ESPN.
So I'm at Quick Trip last night. I had achieved two of the offers. Spend $15, you get 15 cents off gas. And then they had another one a couple days later. So I go to the pump, 30 cents off. They stack on top of each other. Put in 20 gallons of gas because I made sure I waited until my tank was almost empty. May have overfilled to get to an even number of dollars as well.
Heck yeah. Hey, didn't you say you had a Quick Trip story from like last week that you wanted to share with us?
So I'll tell you this, and they have no idea that the folks that were answering my email had no idea that they're a partner of our show. I didn't mention any of that. All I said was, look, one of these offers that I used yesterday, I made the purchase, but, and this is an important tip for those of you that have joined the Quick Rewards, you have to make sure you activate it beforehand. So you go into the app, you activate it, and then you make your purchase, and then you get your your discount on gas or whatever it is. And I threw myself on the mercy of the court. They said they're very responsive with messaging, and they said, you know, you're an idiot, but we'll make an exception in your case this one time. They said it much nicer than that. But I was able to get my 15 cents off a gallon. So I was really excited. They were great. Great customer service, great experience. They could have been tough and said, no, just be smart enough to answer that before you make your purchase. But they didn't. It was great. And I got a response the very same day. So I was really impressed with them. And Tausch is really impressed with their chicken for life.
Best chicken. Yeah, you better believe they have the best chicken. Chicken tenders, roasted chicken, all the chicken you could possibly want. Put it up against anybody. If you haven't tried it, what the heck are you doing? Get into your nearest Quick Trip, pick some up. You won't be disappointed. And we don't have many days left in this deal. We've been raving about it for weeks. Right now, you got that $9.99 eight-piece tenders or bone-in chicken until April 8th. It is perfect for a quick, easy dinner. But wait, there's more. You can win Quick Trip chicken. Fried chicken, not for 2 weeks, not for a decade, not for a century, depending on as the world keeps going.
Wait
a minute. I've read a couple of books. There's some stuff going on. Get automatically entered for a chance to win by purchasing any fried chicken product using your Quick Rewards. You get tenders, bone-in, boneless, crispy chicken sandwiches. All you do, use those Quick Rewards Jason was just talking about. Be entered to win at a chance for an eight-piece bone-in fried chicken a week for life. You must be 18 years or older. See all of the details at quicktrip.com/friedchickenforlife.
Just to clarify, these books that you've been reading, that there's some stuff going on, that's not the same as the stuff that Gina Della's got going on that she's been doing to be sleek?
No,
these
totally
are different.
Okay. Totally different.
I didn't want anyone to leave the conversation confused. What books are you reading?
A lot of different kinds
of stuff going on.
The way you've been using there's some stuff going on, I'm guessing by the time we get to training camp, Jason will be reporting from the sidelines, hosting the show, and we'll say, how's it looking? Yeah, there's some stuff going on. And that'll be the analysis we get for the
day. Been reading a couple of books. All right, we will kick off the 11 o'clock hour. There is scheduled a rendition of Where's Wildy, which I don't remember the last time we played that. Wonder if I said something really interesting that prompted Jesse to play that. We'll find out during the 11 o'clock hour, which kicks off in 2 minutes. So stick around. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here, and when I was on the hunt for a hot tub, I found Patio Pleasures, a locally owned family business. Patio Pleasures has a passion for making your home a place for recovery and relaxation. And that's why I'm excited about my new cold plunge from Patio Pleasures. They only showcase premium recovery and relaxation products, and that's how I know it's going to be great. Gear up for spring and check out Patio Pleasures' two incredible showrooms, Madison West and Sun Prairie.
Hi, this is former Badger Pro Football Hall of Famer Joe Thomas. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN WTLX Monona, Madison. Good Karma Brands radio station.
Broadcasting live from the Everlight Solar Studio, this is your Metro Kia of Madison Sports Center.
Good morning, Madison and streamers everywhere. I'm Jesse Nelson, Sports Center, brought to you by A Banner Year, celebrating the 10-year anniversary of the first of the back-to-back Final Four appearances for Wisconsin men's basketball. All four episode podcasts are now available. Subscribe to the Varsity Podcast on Apple, Spotify, and Wisconsin On Demand. You can also catch full replays of all four episodes Saturday morning starting at 8 a.m. and Sunday morning starting at 10 a.m. this weekend right here on 100.5 ESPN. Tonight, busy night in the city of Milwaukee. Couple of games going on. The Milwaukee Bucks play host to the Toronto Raptors at 7 o'clock at Fiserv Forum. Pre-game coverage starts at 6:30 right here on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN. Milwaukee listed as a 15-point favorite for tonight's game, according to ESPN Bet, despite coming off back-to-back losses to two of the worst teams in the NBA, the Memphis Grizzlies and the Washington Wizards earlier this week. The Bucks entering play today, still in the number two position in the Eastern Conference playoff picture. They cannot catch the Boston Celtics, who have clinched the number one seed and home court advantage through the remainder of the playoffs. The Milwaukee Brewers at home hosting the Seattle Mariners tonight, 7:10 first pitch. Freddie Peralta, opening day starter on the mound.
Metro Kia of Madison, Madison's trusted Kia dealer. Stop into Metro Kia on the east side of Madison or MetroKiaOfMadison.com.
Of Wilde and Tausch begins now. And it begins with something else that we heard Matt LaFleur say during his conversation with Kevin Clark, talking about the development of Jordan Love. And I spent some time talking this morning and yesterday with Alex Strofe and Jim Rutledge on Rutledge and Hamilton Without Hamilton about how much buzz there really is about Jordan Love, and I don't think this would squelch any of that buzz. Here's Matt LaFleur again with Kevin Clark in their podcast, This Is Football.
Oh, the growth has been incredible. It's been phenomenal. He is so much fun to work with. He's a guy that continually learns from both the great plays and the not-so-great plays, so I'm excited about what the future has in store for him.
So he is, you can hear it in his voice, Tausch, and again, I don't want to make this a comp with Rodgers, but I have to, but I'm going to. I think there were times where it was really not very fun for Matt LaFleur. And you can hear the enjoyment, and not just in that clip, but in many clips and in conversations we've had with him and I've had with him. He really is loving working with Jordan Love. There's no doubt about that. My question for you is, I think every time he talks about growth, I think it underscores the fact that there were doubts, right? Because if he doesn't grow by these leaps and bounds that everybody's talking about, he doesn't end up being as good as he appears to be. And so it's great now. How much more growth do you see for him? Because that's all we talked about last year, was how much growth he had shown, and deservedly so. But green and growing ain't enough. Eventually, it's got to be green and winning. And I think he's capable of that. But how much growth is still ahead for him?
Well, I think there's still, you know, he has not hit his ceiling by any stretch. I think we saw moments where you think, this guy's really good. And then we saw what we saw in the fourth quarter against San Francisco. When the money was on the line, it didn't get done. And that was the first time I felt like the moment kind of got him. I think he pressed and he forced some things and did some things that were uncharacteristic of what we saw in the last 10 weeks of his kind of real accelerated growth. So there, it all comes down to consistency, and I think young players strive for that, and you want to start getting to the point where you know, all right, this is what this guy's going to do production-wise. Boom, this is where he's at. And I think the thing that Matt LaFleur is excited about is he still feels like he's malleable. Mm-hmm. This isn't some 15-year veteran that's got, ah, well, I'm going to check to this because this is what we got. And I know this, this, this. There's still the yearning for teaching and for growth of, well, I don't have all the answers. I think that's the part of it I think that's going to be really interesting. And the fact that Matt LaFleur can continue to grow with him, understanding different concepts. But the skill set and the talent that we think we all heard about, it was the accuracy part of it. Having your feet married to what you're doing, throwing the football. Mm-hmm. We saw a monstrous amount of growth there because there was a stretch, even when he played well early in the season for bits and pieces, and when he was awesome in Atlanta
glimpses,
for a vast majority of that
glimpses
game,
of brilliance, some have said.
There still turned out where there were some mistakes and some things. The accuracy was the big concern. And you took, you know, some of us that were saying, well, I'm still worried about the accuracy. Oh, you can't. Well, no, you can't live in the NFL being a 53% completion. That's not the way the league is. You need to be 66-plus. If you want to be big boy 65-plus, that's what you need to be in this league now.
Sure.
Jordan was that at the end of the season. So all of those things, his growth was awesome to watch. But now it's, can you do it week in and week out? Can you consistently make all of those right reads? And I still think, if I'm Matt LaFleur and you're looking at all of his snaps and Tom Clements and everybody else, I still think some of those touch passes underneath screens, there are some things that I still think he has a long way to go. And putting the right touch on it, his arm angles, he's got so much stuff that he's shown already that are only going to improve, because the thing that I love hearing from Goody and everybody else is his approach and all the things that we kind of joked about, all of his positives last year when we didn't know anything about how he could play, team leadership and work ethic and all those positives. Well, now we've seen that, and you marry that up with the talent, that's when you can get excited as a Packer fan that it's going to be that much better.
All right, so I love Ted Lasso. One of the lines in, I think it's in season two, Coach Beard says to him, every person is a different person. And it's important to remember that, right? Because we do a lot of comparing of people and stuff like that around here. I am sure, you use the word malleable. I am sure that Aaron Rodgers in 06, 07, 08, 09, 10 was malleable, right? Even as maybe strong-willed as he can be at times. And then eventually he stopped being malleable. Would you have seen that coming as his teammate then? Because I don't see that coming for Jordan Love, where he gets to the point where I know more than you, I'm the one who's out there, I'm going to do my own thing. It's hard for me to picture him that way with his personality and what I've seen from him thus far. But again, as David Bakhtiari said, you don't know what people become until they get paid the really, really big bucks. And he said he doesn't think Jordan would change either.
Yeah, you know what? None of us know, and from my perspective with Aaron was not that guy when I left. Like, he had just won a Super Bowl. He had not had an MVP. So it's easy to say when you're a young player and you're with the same guys that you started with, and there's not that, whoa, that's Aaron Blank and Rodgers. Oh, that's Jordan's not there yet. But if you think that Jordan Love is going to be the same cat in 8 years that he is right now, if he has a couple MVPs, he's not. People grow. People, relationships change. How you're viewed by your teammates and by your organization change. And it's not always that you change. It's people change how they approach their interactions with you.
No doubt. Yeah.
And then that changes you. So it is not some easy, oh, well, Jordan's going to be this same guy when he's 32 years old. No, he won't be. That doesn't mean it's bad. It doesn't mean it's going to be better. But it's not how the world works, and especially it's not how the world works for star quarterbacks in the NFL. You think Tom Brady is the same? Go watch that dynasty. Tom Brady slamming beers with his O-line and all that, and then next thing 10 years down the road, he's sucking down avocado shakes with Brazilian models. And it's a different world. And I hope Jordan Love gets to the point where he's got the same problems Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers, all these other Pat Mahomes. I hope that happens because you know what? That means there's a lot of success coming for that young man.
I hate to compliment you, but you have never really changed. I'm wondering, though, once you get on the Johnson & Sons paving crew and they start seeing your knowledge, are you going to be malleable like that concrete, or are you going to start saying, hey, I got a lot of experience here. Maybe you guys should listen to me instead of me listening to you. I may be the intern around here, but I'm knowledgeable.
Well, I have a vast knowledge of concrete. Don't have as much an asphalt. So that's why I hope they put me on an asphalt crew and I get to drive that yellow a little smoother because I don't. And then I'll have to listen because they have all that expertise. Mm-hmm. Two civil engineers on staff, a team with decades of experience. They've seen it all. And now if you're looking to get some work done, book with Johnson & Sons Paving. And if you want old T to get out there, time is winding down. Get signed up, johnsonandsonspaving.com. Get on there. I'm not sure where we're going to end up. I don't know what day we're going to end up doing it. I don't know any of that. But if you're looking to get your job done, get moving. Those preferred dates, get booked up. johnsonandsonspaving.com.
I think the Green Bay Airport should put in a request for a job.
Oh, geez.
And then you could help extend the runways so the Packers could fly to Brazil.
That has to be getting announced here this week, right? If they're doing it,
what's the holdup?
Murphy said he thought they were going to announce it last week. It's been an entire week since then, so they must really want the Packers to go.
Arm twisting is occurring. I'm sure it's the Green Bay Mayor's fault. We will play some Where's Wildy next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
This is Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella today, 855-PELLA-WI, and online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Mark Tauscher here for the great team at Everlight Solar. Well, the return of baseball and the countdown to the start of basketball's playoffs also mean the days are getting longer. And more sunlight means more encouragement to make the energy switch to Everlight Solar. Wouldn't you love to have a way to save money and save the planet? Well, good news, there is a way. It's by making the switch to solar. Our family is one of many who have made the switch to solar over the last several years. But when we first started, we weren't exactly sure what to do. So when we met with the Everlight Solar team and they outlined the entire process and educated us on the benefits of making the switch, it was super simple. Join us in saving a ton of money and creating a greener environment for our family and the community by switching to solar. Learn more and schedule a free consultation at EverlightSolar.com. That's EverlightSolar.com.
From the biggest plays on the court to the comments made in the locker room after, an in-depth recap of every Bucks game in 6 minutes. No more, no less. Bucks in Six provides game recaps for every game. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis.
Puts it on the floor, spins down the lane, and plunges it through.
Or the deep threes from Dame.
Dame time has arrived with 107.
Bucks in Six on the Bucks Plus Audio Network. Find it now. Now on Bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, and wherever you get your podcasts.
Hey, it's Alex Stroh. Stay in the know on area high school sports and follow ESPN Madison on Twitter for Prep Mania on Deck, each week's preview of the top games and events. Prep Mania on Deck is brought to you by Zimbrick Honda, a proud supporter of high school sports and local communities.
Cousin Subs was founded in Milwaukee, Wisconsin in 1972 and has been a member of the Madison community for decades. This year, Cousins has expanded their footprint in the Madison area by opening new locations in Stoughton and Sun Prairie, in addition to existing locations on East Washington Avenue, Monona, and Lodi. Order your favorite subs online or via our app for delivery or pickup. Eat in or grab them to go through our drive-thru for a better sub experience. Cousin Subs, we believe in better.
To those who've ever dreamt of their perfect event, those dreams are worthy and they are possible. Hi, it's Jeffrey from Celebrations Entertainment. With hard work, passion, and great music, we will make your event dreams a reality. Every event is a labor of love, with one-on-one planning, customization, and flawless execution. Bringing your event to life is what we do. For a fun, memorable event, visit CelebrationsEntertainment.com. That's CelebrationsEntertainment.com.
If you're looking for a special piece of jewelry for any occasion, Condon Jewelers is always there for you. Condon Jewelers has the best selection of jewelry you'll ever find and guaranteed to have the lowest prices in the Madison area. Free shipping is always available. Visit CondonJeweler.com or call 241-3406 and ask for Jim the owner, who's at the store every day. Shop locally. Condon Jewelers, the jeweler on the east side, the jeweler on your side.
You're probably being overwhelmed with information about semaglutide, the game-changing FDA-approved weight loss treatment. Jim Rutledge here. I was like you. I didn't know what it was until I saw Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health. He can walk you through the benefits. He can tell you if it's right for you, and then you could come up with a plan to change your life with a workout plan and semaglutide. With that plan, I dropped 20% body fat to 10% body fat, and I dropped over 20 pounds of fat and kept my muscle. You can do the same thing. Go see Dr. Nestor Rodriguez at Carbon World Health.
Since J&K Security Solutions opened in 1987, our attention to detail and customer service have been our strongest assets. I'm President Jeffrey Beckman. We'll always do our best to find the most efficient and cost-effective solution to every job we tackle. Whether it's security for your home or business, installing video surveillance, or being able to control your garage doors from your phone, we can help you feel empowered with simple and user-friendly technology. Let's work together to secure your home or business. JKSecurity.com.
Wilde and Tausch on 100.5 ESPN is brought to you by Everlight Solar. Save money, save the planet. Everlight Solar.
So long, and I'm sure won't live up to the advanced billing of "You Can Only Prevent Forest Fires," but it's time now for Where's Wilde.
Since he often saves his best material for other shows,
if there's something difficult we need to talk about, let's have the conversation.
We're bringing the other shows to us.
I would be very leery if I was a Packers fan.
Or are we?
Tausch takes a lot of days, man.
It's time to play Where's Wilde.
It is, and it has been a while. Let's find out where Jason shared some of his best material over the last week on the ESPN Wisconsin airwaves. Tausch, remember the rules. WTMJ or ESPN Chicago or ESPN National, those do not qualify for the game that we're playing here.
Mm-hmm.
Just want to make sure we're all on the same page because it's been a while since we've played. Here is clip number one.
I think he's become a believer in the idea that it's more than ever a young man's game, and getting inexpensive young players and getting them to execute and play well is the way to go. And I'll be curious to see if we see them give out fewer second contracts to good players moving forward, or if there'll be some players that are good enough that they say, you know what, even though this guy's 26 and he'll be, you know, 30 by the time this contract ends, we will give him a second contract. Because I'm convinced that he's convinced that he doesn't want guys, very many, if any, guys that have had their 30th birthday on his team.
Where's Wilde?
He being Brian
So
Gutekunst.
None of these... I figured that was the case. We're, you're not doing any Wilde and Tausch, right? This is all somewhere else.
I didn't say that.
No, you forgot. Been so long, you've forgotten the rules.
Wilde and Tausch is on the ESPN Wisconsin airwaves.
Yeah, and Jason, when I'm out, is allowed to talk more. He doesn't get interrupted. Asked questions.
Now, I will say this for you, Tausch. Because you've complained about the malfeasance of doctoring the audio over the years, there will never be any doctored audio to make it sound like a phone call.
Ooh.
When he's speaking into a microphone.
Gotcha.
We won't do that anymore.
Okay.
We won't try to fool you that
All right,
bad.
I'm going to say this is KBN. Jason's point is really interesting. I wish he'd say that on Wilde and Tausch again. I have to take some blame for that because by all accounts, when Gary Ellerson and Bulaga are hosting, Jason talks and answers more questions and everything else. But this whole concept of not getting a second contract, that is bunk, Jason. great players that are 24 are not going to be walking out this building. But the third contract, and Kenny Clark's going to be a really,
that's
really
who,
interesting
That's what
case.
Prompted this conversation is Kenny Clark,
I believe
by the way.
That. The well, then that was yesterday on our show with Domofsky.
I think
the,
so, too.
The actual, well, I'm not going to go there. I've already said KBN. But this whole concept of, and especially if you have five wideouts like you do that are all in that first, second-year deal, I think it's going to be more preemptive trade,
yeah,
youth replenishment.
But that,
but if Dontavion Wicks pops and is the guy you think he's going to be, I would guess that you're going to see contracts handed out year 3-4. You're not going to let guys get to that fifth year where you're going to be paying top dollar. You're going to preemptively go. But Goody has been very adamant about not giving that third deal. And the Kenny Clark component of this is going to be zero interesante.
You just combined two different languages there. That's pretty good, right? Interessante, not German. Sehr, very German. Look, I think it's KBN too, but I don't want you to misinterpret my point. Yes, there will still be guys that get second contracts, but I think you just agreed with me without knowing it. I think there's going to be guys like, whether it's John Runyan, who maybe in the past would have gotten that second contract and played well and gotten kind of a middling second contract. I think there's going to be guys that would you would want to give a second contract to. But part of the conversation that I was having with, I think, Kyle that prompted this, and Jesse, tell me if I'm wrong. Did we get this right, KBN?
Rutledge and Hamilton, weekdays 4 to 6 on 100.5
I also
ESPN.
Talked to them. But the conversation was, you know, all these guys that Goody has brought in and that draft class from last year, they're all going to hit free agency at the same time. And so if you believe in the young man's game and you want to replenish, there are going to be guys that might have gotten a second contract before that won't now because you've got four different guys that are up for them. And you'll move on to from some of them where maybe you wouldn't have previously.
Yeah, and I think you're going to see more preemptiveness.
Uh-huh.
As far as both getting guys' deals done and potentially trading trading guys, although Russ loves that compensatory pick pool deal. He loves it, and they manipulate it as good as anybody does. So if you end up with, let's say, Reed, which I think Reed's going to be one of your core guys, but let's say Christian Watson has a great fourth or fifth year, all of a sudden then, well, somebody's going to get, and you're going to end up getting a third round pick because somebody's going to pay him. You kind of let him play, and unless you're getting better than that third round pick, you just hang on to him. But if you can get a second around the trade deadline, you might start seeing more of that maneuvering by Goody at the back end of these guys' rookie deals.
So, real quick, because Watson, the Packers tried to trade for the Vikings' first round pick, number 32 overall, which would have gotten the fifth-year option for him. Instead, he ends up being a second-round pick. So they'll have to, like, he's going into year three. Like, this is a critical year for him to decide whether you can even be preemptive with him or not. Otherwise, he's going to have to go into year four. And then he might be one of the ones that, despite being a second-round pick, despite being a guy that you really like, if he hasn't shown the durability or he has a breakout fourth season and he prices himself out, you don't give him a second contract, right?
Yeah, and also you're going to look at it and say, well, man, Dontavion Wicks is balling.
Right.
He's going into his third year. Maybe we pay him a big deal, and then Christian Watson knows he's – and that's why when we are talking ensemble versus the one, it just isn't as easy. Mm-hmm. It's not as simple because – things change, dynamics change, rooms change. Even though the guys in the rooms don't, the mentality in the room changes. Money changes things.
Next,
God, I got that one right.
Where's Wildy?
So I thought you got it right too, but I think I had a similar conversation with Kyle and Bruss. There was no Nortman the other day.
No chance to get on the board here with clip number two.
From talking to someone who works for the building, after this whole thing kind of re-flamed up, because I wrote about this over a week ago, I do think that for Matt, you know, from what I understand from this person that I talked to yesterday, he and Goody have actually been in a much better place the last year or so than they had been before. I do think that there was frustration. that they were so young last year and that they were struggling, and that I think the coaches were concerned that this was going to be viewed as, quote-unquote, their fault that they were 2-5. I do think that Goody and LaFleur are in a good place now.
Where's Wildy?
That sounds morning walk-ish, Jen, Gabe, and Chewy to me, now that we're not doctoring the audio. And
well, the audio's bad.
I think your point on that, I think, and we've said this all week, when Balaga joined us, the coaches felt a lot of pressure last year because if they didn't show growth, and I think Goody put a lot on by having this roster overhaul and the youth movement, and the general manager felt pressure that these guys, it was going to be, the season played out the way it was in September and October, there are going to be a lot of shrapnel coming in, a lot of people, and everybody was putting their bunkers up.
You're right.
And when you put bunkers up, there's a lot of miscommunication. There's a lot of, well, I didn't say that, I didn't do this. And that's why I think the Matt LaFleur component of this backtrack off of what he said, because it didn't go Bunkersville. You ended up having a hell of a year, and everybody's looking at Matt LaFleur in a better light than they did actually when Aaron Rodgers was the quarterback. Because of the development and the growth and Matt LaFleur's offense actually getting to shine and Matt getting the credit for it, developing Jordan. So I think Matt LaFleur is looking at this like, I don't want any more consternation about this. I didn't mean to say I don't know what the hell is going on, even though
I didn't know what the hell was going on.
Exactly was going on.
I'm going to say the Homer Hour.
One of you is right. The Homer Hour. Weekdays 5 to 6 on 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee and 1430 ESPN Beaver Dam.
All right, we got time for one more?
This game sucks. By the way, this game sucks.
We can only play it once every 3 months.
Because this game sucks.
Tausch, I believe in you on this last one. Here is clip number 3.
So he was active this year with Josh Jacobs replacing – I mean, he swapped out a stud running back for a younger stud running back. And they added a safety who they paid a pretty penny for and who better be a field-tilting player for them, given the expectations. But between that 19 free agent group that we talked about with the Smith brothers, Billy Turner, and Adrian Amos, and these two guys, they haven't done jack in free agency.
Where's Wildy?
Pretty strong.
Very frustrated. My little squish ball is popped. It's got a little hole. Do you see it?
It's oozing.
Do I have to dump it? This has been a good squish ball for a while, but it's leakage. Do I have to just dump it?
Yeah. I mean, it can't
I think
do
you
the
should
job
squeeze. With the oozing that has begun, I think we should do a digi only where you're squeezing out the. That Dr. Pimple Popper show is really popular. I would think that people would tune in just to watch you squeeze out the ooze.
Save it for when we're talking about things being worth the squeeze.
Yeah, that's a good call. I think this is going to be Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
Jason?
I think it's going to be KBN. We're not even going to bother with if there's anything interesting said in there.
That was Jason's appearance with Gary Ellerson and Jesse Nelson
as a guest on Wildy and
Tausch.
I should have known. Jesse's ego was going to definitely let him when
Come,
he was
I
the
I thought you soul. Would know that one.
I should have known. That's, you know what? I can't complain about the game on that one. That one I complain about old T. That was a mistake. I should have known you were going to fit one of those in there. Normally you put it right away in case we don't get to it, though. That's why I asked, is Wildy and Tausch available for it? And I was wrong. Tough.
I can't wait to play it again in July. That is it for Whoa, Nelly, Jason Wildy, Where's Wildy, all that other good stuff. We can all agree on this, though, that right now is a great time to shop at Fleet Farm. I just got another notification. I got 5 more Fleet Bucks. I'm up to 15 Fleet Bucks that I get to spend, and I can spend it at Fleet Farm's Truckload Savings event, which is back and is underway. It started yesterday. It runs through Sunday. You can haul away huge deals. Stock up on everyday essentials like wild bird food, garden soil, and more. These days last for only 4 days only, these deals. So shop now. Hurry in before they're gone. Check out fleetfarm.com to find out more, or check out the app as well. Whoa, Nelly. And Feel Good Friday still ahead. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch, driven by Zimbrick Chevrolet in Sun Prairie on 100.5 ESPN. See their full inventory at ZimbrickChevrolet.com.
Prize Picks is America's number one fantasy sports app with over 3 million active members. They are the easiest and most exciting way to play daily fantasy sports. All you do, pick more or less on a 2-6 player stat projection and watch the winnings roll in. Whether it's tournament season or the fight for playoff home court, there's no shortage of high-stakes basketball moments this time of year. Prize Picks even offers injury insurance so that your entries stay in play even if one of your players gets hurt. For basketball games, if you have a player who exits the game in the first half and does not return in the second, Prize Picks will have your back and not count that as a loss. Prize Picks is really simple to play. I can make my picks and submit my entry in less than 60 seconds. Prize Picks also offers weekly promotions and special offers for the biggest moments in sports. Download the app today and use code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a deposit match up to $100. Pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
Mike Greenberg. Green.
If we're just talking about the football piece of it, Aaron Rodgers, from the moment he got there until the moment he got hurt, was the best leader the Jets have had since Rex Ryan. Whatever you think of his politics, his social positions, or anything else, if you're a football fan, if you're a fan of the Jets, I would rather have Aaron Rodgers setting the tone than anyone else they have in the building.
Greeny, weekdays noon to 2 on 100.5 ESPN.
Attention, business owners and executives. Looking for a bank that's invested in your community as you are? Look no further than Starion Bank. As a Dane County community bank, Starion offers competitive deposit and loan rates while actively supporting local initiatives. Visit a business banker at one of our convenient branches in Middleton, Monona, and Sun Prairie. Starion Bank, full-service business banking, lending, and cash management.
Greg Scalzo here for Buck and Honey's. Congratulations to the perennial Best of Madison Award winner by the folks at Madison Magazine. Meet me at Buck and Honey's to celebrate Wisconsin hospitality. Whether you're enjoying the view on the Yahara River in Monona, exploring Wanakee, visiting the OG in Sun Prairie, or checking out the new location in Mount Horeb, you can enjoy the Buck and Honey's experience in a neighborhood near you. Serving lunch and dinner 7 days a week with brunch every Saturday and Sunday. I'll see you at Buck and Honey's.
If you're an employer looking to tap into the next strong generation of local prospective employees, then you can't miss this. 95.3 WBEV ESPN Beaver Dam and DailyDodge.com will be hosting the South Central Wisconsin Career Expo on April 23rd. From 9:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Beaver Dam High School Fieldhouse, businesses will have the opportunity to meet with hundreds of eager juniors and seniors from area high schools, as well as adult job seekers. Employers can find more information and purchase a booth on the Career Expo page at DailyDodge.com.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
It's Chevy truck season, and there's no better time to do what you do best. No better time to get the job done in a Chevy Silverado with best-in-class standard torque and a Turbomax engine with a 5-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty that outlasts both Ford and Ram. So kick off whatever your thing is season right, because it all starts with a Chevy truck.
See your Badgerland Chevy dealer today.
Based on latest competitive data, excludes other GM vehicles, whichever comes first. See dealer for limited warranty details based on Ford and Ram 5-year, 60,000-mile warranty on gasoline engines.
Like, share, and follow ESPN Madison everywhere. Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok for more great content from ESPN Madison. This is 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
With tears in my eyes, love in my soul, I feel like starting something. The pain had subsides, the
So we're going to skip Wonelli, but we do need to pick this week's trivia winner. So, Jesse, you want to make that selection for us?
I will do that right now. Only one contestant has all five chips in the helmet this week, and it's today's contestant. So let's see how we do here. Oh, it wasn't today's contestant. That's right. Congratulations to Andrew in Fitchburg, who was Wednesday's Wisconsin-Italy Geography Wednesday.
He's a first-timer, wasn't he?
He may have been. I didn't write it down, but he may have been. Congratulations to Andrew. Okay.
So we got some sad news yesterday, and that was that Larry Bechtel, who was the Packers offensive line coach from 1999 through 2005. He'd also coached for the Jets, the Oilers, the Dolphins, the Lions, the Buccaneers, the Falcons. I mean, he was a lifer. Passed away yesterday at age 81. And Tausch, I know how much appreciation you have for the two offensive line coaches that were so influential for you as an NFL player. But the minute I saw this, I thought of you, and I thought this is going to hit Tausch pretty hard, and I'm guessing that it did.
Yeah, it was a tough day. I got a text from Marco. There was probably a group of six or seven of us on there, and, you know, Big Beck was instrumental for me and for a lot of us, you know, from a career standpoint. We were talking about draft picks earlier, and, you know, him trusting to put a seventh rounder out there and working with me, and it was a tough day because, you know, you're going through life and, you know, day to day, and then there's when you get hit with something that a person who made a big impact in your life, and when they pass away, it makes you think a lot. But a lot of gratitude for what he was able to you know, help me with, and I'm just one of many, but, you know, we were discussing it on our text chain and stuff, and what a character. I don't know if you'll see, you know, a character like him in today's day and age. He was loud, he was passionate, and he loved coaching offensive linemen, and I think there was some navigating with him all the time. He didn't do things in probably the most politically correct or the most structured ways, but he meant a lot. He's meant a lot to me in my life, and, you know, I would not have had the career I had without Larry Bechtel.
So the Packers actually hire him the year before you arrived. He was on Ray Rhodes' staff, and he was one of the few coaches that stayed and kept on staff when Mike Sherman came along, and so Mike Sherman then had him on his staff from 2000 through 2005, and then obviously there's the entire change after that season. So when, you know, I just remember him chomping his gum, and he went, Jason! He was always teaching me, because he always thought I was an idiot, and he was right, about offensive line play, and that is, you know, he was the one who signed off on me getting to sit in on that meeting with you guys. You know, he had to say it was okay. Man, did he give me some grief that day. But he was, you're right, he was such a character. I guess I'm wondering, obviously I understood when I saw the news what he had meant to you, but it wasn't just you. Like, I'm guessing that all those guys on that text chain yesterday were feeling a lot of the same feelings that you were feeling about a guy who coached one more year in the NFL. He coached one more year with the Lions in 06, and then he retired. Did you stay in contact with him, and can you kind of articulate what he meant, not just to you, but to the Marcos and the Mike Walls and the Mike Flanagans and all those guys that he impacted, not just you?
Yeah, I think everybody had different relationships with their coaches. Some thought they were great, but to a man, every one of us, even though some disagreed with his personality, and he was, like I said, he's not for everybody. But I think the one thing that we all unanimously would say is that he knew his blank. Like, he knew his football. He'd been around a long time, knows what works, what didn't work, and he pushed us. And he put us in positions to win. We had a heck of a lot of fun. And where it really, you know, hit me yesterday is when Marco sent the text that his wife had said how much fun and how meaningful it was the time he had with our group and the success that we had. That was the when it hit me, probably the hardest.
That was a great group, arguably the greatest in Packers history. Did you get to talk to him much in the intervening years after he retired, after you retired?
So he was able to, he obviously came up for my Packer Hall of Fame thing. We saw him out at Ron Wolf's out in, his last couple years were tough. Yeah. He had some tough stuff going on, but we would, you know, he'd still call, you know, he would, so we tried to stay in as much touch as you can, but for probably the 5 or 6 years prior to when he started declining a little bit, yeah, we tried to stay in touch. And, again, it's just another great reminder of making sure you let people know how you feel about them when they're around.
Larry Bechtel was 81 years old, and he had an impact on countless offensive linemen throughout the NFL. He actually got his coaching start, obviously, at the college level at a variety of schools, NC State, Auburn, Arkansas. He actually spent a year, and I don't know how many times he brought this up, but he was actually the head coach at Louisiana Tech in 1979. I would have loved to have attended those press conferences on a regular basis. Those would not have been dull from the head coach of the Bulldogs.
Was always fun because, you know, his knees were bad, and he would always kind of let us in on how he was doing health-wise and, you know, chomping around. But it just – I could still hear his voice in my head.
Very distinctive.
That, just that old – yes. He had that very distinctive voice. But, again, man, allowed us to have a ton of success with how he approached things and how he pushed us as a group. And I think all of us are eternally grateful to Beck for helping us in our careers.
So, obviously, there are certain players, you know, the Walter Joneses, the Joe Thomases, that are just supremely gifted, right? We all understand that. And I am not in any way undercutting your or any of the guys' talent that you played with. But I've heard you talk so many times over the years that we've known each other about Larry Bechtel and James Campen. When it comes to that position, and I heard something from the NFL meetings. It was Harbaugh talking about offensive line and how it's the one position that if it doesn't play well, everything can go to hell, basically, for your offense, right? And it's the one unit that gets talked about as a unit. No, not even defensive line gets talked about that way. It's always the offensive line. So how critical is it to have a great offensive line coach? And if you don't have one, how much trouble are you in as an NFL team?
Well, it's the hardest job probably in football because – you have to get everybody working together. Everybody has to understand and see things the same way. You can't sit there and I'd always remember coaches, both Campy and Beck, would say, even if you make the wrong call, make sure you're all doing the wrong thing so that at least you have a chance. Because you can't have it where one guy is sitting there and, oh, well, I thought you were protecting here and you were doing this. And so it was always about communicating. And what Beck was great at was, you know, we had a ton of fun, and he gave us, you know, a lot of, as long as we were getting the job done and, you know, doing what we were supposed to, have a ton of fun with it. But it was always about making sure we were prepared for whatever was going to come our way and that our group understood it. And what made that group so much fun to be around is we had a ton of success. Mm-hmm. And it was because we knew what the hell we were doing.
We will wrap up the show, as we always do on Fridays, with Feel Good Friday. But I think anyone who came across Larry Bechtel during their time, whether they were a player for him or whether they covered him and interviewed him or passed him in the hallway at 1265 Lombardi Avenue, we all remember him vividly and appreciate the interactions we had with him. He may not have been for everyone, but everyone has a Larry Bechtel story, and everyone smiles.
At some point.
And to be honest, there's a bunch of them we do. I'm not going to tell you on air, but there are. And a matter of fact, my Feel
Digi
Good Friday
only?
Will be one with. Yeah, no, I'm not even going to Digi only. My Feel Good Friday one will be with Brett Favre because it was one of the funniest things. It was good.
Tausch will.
The old airplane rides.
Tausch will share that story to wrap things up. Feel Good Friday, painted by Holman Lindsay, paints next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
The Milwaukee Bucks. The Toronto Raptors.
Giannis sees Capella between him. Oh, what a spin move. Goes right around Capella and lays it in with a foul.
Tonight on Madison's home of the Bucks, 100.5 ESPN.
Mark Tauscher here, and it's another Feel Good Friday on Wilde and Tausch, painted by Holman Lindsay Paints. Baseball is back in full swing, and you know what that means. It's also time to get ready to tackle all those spring projects around the house. If that includes painting, I encourage you to do what my family did and get connected with the pro painters at Holman Lindsay. It's super easy. Stop into one of the many Holman Lindsay locations around the Madison area, and the friendly staff will help you connect with the right pros to help complete your project. And remember, Wisconsin's best painters use Wisconsin's best paint, and Wisconsin's best painters are the pro painters at Holman Lindsay Paints. Check them out at HolmanLindsay.com. That's HolmanLindsay.com. Holman Lindsay, great paint, great people. Stay tuned for Feel Good Friday, coming up to close out today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, painted by Holman Lindsay Paints.
You, rah, rah. Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by the Great Dane Pub and Brewing Company, Madison's home for craft beer and pub food since 1994. Find the Great Dane nearest you at greatdanepub.com. According to a report Wednesday in The Athletic, college presidents and top executives have devised a super league to change college football, as they believe the current system is doomed and headed for bankruptcy. According to Andrew Marchand, former Wisconsin football player Mark Tauscher joined Rutledge and Hamilton on ESPN Wisconsin to react to the news.
It's unlimited free agency. That system is not going to be tenable for a vast majority of these college programs, and I think everybody sees that.
Find the full conversation with Tauscher on Wisconsin On Demand or wherever you get your podcasts.
Badger Minutes on ESPN Wisconsin are brought to you by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Schedule an appointment online today at PellaWI.com.
Waiting to see a general surgeon? With Stoughton Health, it's always easy access, with most appointments within a week. And with over 160 insurances accepted, you're covered and in good hands. For more information, visit StoughtonHealth.com. Stoughton Health, creating excellence together.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Hey, so have you tried fried chicken from Quick Trip? Ooh, freshly cooked, hot, and ready. And I'm talking jumbo, hand-breaded chicken tenders, boneless wings dripping with all your favorite sauces. Or how about 8 pieces of fried chicken deliciousness? Perfect for your next large group meal. I mean, this is fried chicken that slays. I'm not talking about the runway. Slays appetites, fills you up. This is no ordinary chicken, and it'll make any meal extraordinary. Quick Trip fried chicken, ready for your next meal. See you next time.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. When you're ready to get out and prep your yard for spring, we get you the right products at the right prices. Right now, rewards members get a free $15 gift card with a $100 purchase of Scotts products. Like Scotts Turf Builder Lawn Food, $49.99 after sale and mail-in rebate. Scotts GrubX Season-Long Grub Killer, $24.99 after sale and rebate. And save $2 on select bags of Miracle-Gro Potting Mix. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
Mark Tauscher here for Chalmers Jewelers. I've been a big fan of Scott and Garrett and the whole team at Chalmers Jewelers for years now. I go there, my friends go there, and most importantly, my wife loves it whenever I get her something from Chalmers Jewelers. What's right around the corner? Mother's Day. Show some love to the incredible women in your life and stop at Chalmers Jewelers, the place to go for that perfect gift. I recommend Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton and Madison.
Chalmers Jewelers in Middleton
and Madison.
You gotta get down on Friday. It's time to finish the week off right. It's Feel Good Friday on Wilde and Tausch, painted by Holman Lindsay.
Hey, feeling good, like I should. When indoors.
I'm not gonna lie. There are probably some stories that would be very entertaining as well that are on the list of can't tell them on the radio stories from Larry Bechtel's time with you. But I'm pretty excited about the one you're about to share because I think I've heard it before.
You probably have, and again, unfortunately, Larry passed away yesterday. But a lot of laughs too along the way, and Brett Favre loves flatulence. Like that's just one of the things I don't know what it is, whether it's fart jokes or whatever it might be. So one of the things that he had a huge he loved whoopee cushions. Like that is Brett loves whoopee cushions, and Larry Bechtel again. He's so he was sitting up. I don't know if he was in first class or he was up in the front of the plane. And, he was always chatty with the flight attendants, and we'd mm-hmm. always have laughs and everything else. So Brett got one of those remote control whoopee machines, whatever it would be. And he sat it under Beck's chair. And Beck couldn't move around great because his knees and everything
else. Bad knees.
So he put it under the chair, and every time the flight attendant would come up and say something like, hey, you need a drink, whatever it might be, he'd just let that thing rip. He'd hit it, and Beck would sit there, and he didn't know. The first five or six times, he had no clue what the hell was going on. So he'd sit there, and everybody's like, Beck, what are you doing? Like, Beck, what are we? So eventually, I don't know. I think it went on for probably half a flight. It was just one of those that it just got so much. And Beck wailing around, trying to figure out how to get that whoopee cushion out from under his seat and everything else. It was just a great lot of fun laughs that were had, and it was – of course, at Larry Bechtel's expense.
So I have heard, so there are variations of this story where he would do it to Lee Remmel, the longtime PR director as well. According to Amazon.com, I don't want to give you any ideas for the next time we have a remote, but you can find a remote-controlled fart machine on Amazon for $16.99.
And I'm guessing Brett got that a lot cheaper back in the day, but yeah, that's that could be something.
I love you guys.
The fact that he would hit the button every time the flight attendants, who I'm sure Beck was chatting it up with, is pretty good. So I'm glad we can think back and smile at some of his stories, but I more importantly, I appreciate your honesty about how much he meant and that vulnerability, because he did mean a lot to you, and I'm glad that you were able to share that. I think we're all better for having heard you talk about that. There's no denying that there are characters in the NFL, but Tausch is right. I don't think there will be another Larry Bechtel, and that I can say without any hesitation whatsoever.
I think it's fair to say he's one of one.
Yeah.
For sure.
That is it for us this week. You got a full week scheduled for us next week too, or
I'll be here. Yeah, I don't have any breaks coming at least for a 5 or 6 week stretch. I think I'm good to go.
Well, we look forward to that. Thanks to everyone who chimed in this week. Certainly the Badgers Outsider today, Rob Domofsky, Evan Cohen, Brian Bulaga, Uncle Homer, Mel Kiper on recording. I can't wait for Jen to get that delivered, the 2000 draft guide. I can't wait to A, confirm that Tausch is in it, and B, see what Mel Kiper said about him. That is going to be fun. So we look forward to Jen joining us once her $103 purchase arrives at her doorstep. Thanks for coming along for the ride with us today and all week. Have a great day. Take care. Be good.
Miss any of today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin? Commercial-free full show podcasts are available free on Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here.